Welcome to the DMC neighbourhood. Everything is peaceful at 2:29 in the morning of the 4th of November 2022. The peace, however, doesn't last too long in the Stratton household. Darren's been having a tough time sleeping, and this movie explains as to why.
Oh, for goodness sake. Why is this dream haunting me every single night? It's getting to the point where I don't know what to do anymore.
Darren, what's wrong? My apple cherry muffin. Is everything okay?
No, they're not. My pet ate a cheese pie. I'm being haunted by the same dream every night, and it's really getting me down.
Is this the same dream where your troublemakers attempt at trying to take over the DMC neighborhood?
That's the exact one, my strawberry marshmallow cake. However, the dreams are getting worse the more I have them.
Oh no, honey, you poor soul. Come here, let me give you a hug.
Thank you very much, my wondrous lemon toffee. I really need it, and then after that, I'll try and settle back down.
Okay, and then we'll see what happens. We have a movie to introduce later, so we will need to have you feeling at your best.
Eight hours later, and we're now in the kitchen of the Stratton household. It's now 10:30 in the morning on the 4th of November 2022. Darren had just arrived downstairs and was just about to have some breakfast when suddenly his phone rings.
Hang on, my luscious pizza slice. I'd better get that, as it sounds like an important phone call.
Is everything okay, Mum? Dad's not been his usual cheerful self as of late, and Roscoe and I are really worrying about him.
I'm not sure, my honey. Your father has been experiencing the same nightmare every night, but they are continually getting worse.
Oh no, Mum. No wonder why Dad's always out of the zone when he wakes up.
And we can understand why as well, Mum. We love our dad to absolute bits, and it hurts us every time we see him down and depressed.
That was a call from my ombudsman. They've noted that things have been bringing me down, and said that they're going to let me have a week off from my video making once everything is done and dusted.
That's good, isn't it, Dad? I mean, they noted that you need a break, and have allowed you to take it.
I'm happy the time to be having the week off, but who's going to take my place whilst that's happening?
I will, of course, my adorably silly sausage. The question now is, what do you plan to do with that week?
I haven't decided yet, my juicy watermelon slice.
No matter what you do, Dad, you'll always have our back.
Thank you very much, my honey. I've got two kids of whom I'm eternally proud of. If it wasn't for you kids, and for you Sarah, the very person I'm both proud and honored to call my wife, I honestly wouldn't know where I'd be right now.
That's so very sweet of you, made toffee cream cake.
I love you guys to absolute pieces. Now then, I'd best head off, because I have a movie to introduce.
Take care, Dad, and know that we are all proud of you.
Best of luck, Dad. Remember where we are if you need anything.
I agree with the kids there, my peachy bear surprise.
Thank you very much. It really does mean a lot to me. Now, the introduction is at the park, so I'd best get going. See you soon, guys. I love you to pieces.
Welcome to the DMC neighbourhood, the neighbourhood where safety and harmony resides, and where friends treat each other like family. The DMC neighbourhood is a secluded neighbourhood based in Cardiff, Wales, and things couldn't be livelier with everything that's to offer.
Hi guys, it's your man Darren Stratton here, and I would like to take the time to welcome you to the DMC neighbourhood. We have so much fun to be had here, with a wide range of activities.
I'm James Barat, and I'm married to a wonderful wife named Millie, and we have three kids to be proud of.
My name is Lily, and I'm one very honored daughter to have ever graced the face of this wonderful neighborhood.
My name is Roscoe Barrett, and I am happy to be going to school here, and living the life a typical boy like me would.
Ramana in the house, and I am absolutely thrilled to be here.
I am Millie Barrett, and I'm one proud wife of this handsome man next to me. Say James, my watermelon cheesecake. How would you like to go to the park with me and the kids?
That'll be brilliant, my marshmallow cream biscuit. Thank you very much.
Not a problem, my wondrous strawberry licorice. Let's get going, and having a great time.
There are a multitude of families that live inside the DMC neighbourhood, and everyone has the same purpose of living the same adventurous life.
Hi guys, my name's Gary Trinsky, and I'm married to Samantha, and we have two kids, Lily and Tom.
My name is Samantha, and my wonderful Jerry Bear is amazing at what he does.
My name is Lily Ringsgate, and my parents are amazing.
Thomas Ringsgate in the house, and I am thrilled at what's going on.
We also have some wonderful friends in the YouTube community who have recently joined us. The YouTube Alliance is a new addition to the DMC neighbourhood, and it consists of all YouTubers who have come to help wherever possible.
Brainiac Adam to the rescue, and I have some heroes of my very own. The Adamantians are a group I'm both proud and honoured to lead.
Hey! My name is Lozzie, and I love spending time in the YouTube Alliance. I will always come to your rescue whenever I'm needed.
Hi, guys. My name is Zalaraxium, and I'm thrilled to be a part of the DMC neighborhood.
Hey. What's up, guys? My name is John Aquilia, and although I wasn't too sure about coming here, I've been reassured that it'll all be alright.
And with more of us coming along soon, things are only going to get better.
However, some known troublemakers are approaching and are threatening to turn even this peaceful world upside down. The people are slowly learning to...
Oh, do shut your mouth, you stupid little narrator. This is my movie, and if I hear you talking one more time, I will put a bunch of size 13 socks into your mouth, and thus turn your face into a stuffed ass end of a turkey.
And we'll make sure that you stay out of action forever, you self-entitled little snitch twit.
As you wish, your royal nuisances, I will hush my mouth for this part only as we get on with this movie.
You will shut your mouth for the rest of this movie. This is my movie, so I call the shots here, not you.
Hi there, constipated losers. My name is Leona Lomax, and although I may look like a sweet little angel, I'm acting like a child of Lucifer, and I couldn't be prouder of my status as a new troublemaker of the League of Entitled Karens.
My name is Lolita Lomax, and things are getting ever better. I plan to take over DMC primary, even though Leona and I have been expelled. However, little do people know at this stage, we have secretly reinstated ourselves, and we set to cause a ruckus at the school.
Hello, my name is Alan Dewberry, and I am a police officer. I strive to do whatever I can to make sure those entitled Karens are in the line. I was born in Adelaide, Australia, and I am loving my time in the DMC neighbourhood, but the thing I actually miss about being in Adelaide is going to Adelaide Oval and watching either Crows or Port Adelaide Power Play.
My name is Mr. Multiple, but you DMC winners can call me Paul. I was born in Georgia, USA, and I gained my multiple name due to the many jobs that I do in the world. I am married to Sally Sunshine, and we have two wonderful kids, Ben and Jerry.
My name is Russell Sherrard, and I come from Melbourne, Australia, and I still can't quite get over how cat-dog-ish the size of my country looks, and it makes me laugh.
Psych! Do you really think I was going to keep my mouth shut? Not a bloody chance. There are more people to feature than who was in the introduction.
Ha. That means there will be more people to recruit in my army. Taryn and I will single-handedly take over the DMC neighborhood. You just watch and learn from the superiors.
We'll be starting off small, and then we'll slowly start to expand from there. You will regret having started this pathetic excuse of a neighborhood when Karen and I take over, and make everyone follow in our footsteps.
You better keep your mouth shut, Karen Stacy and Taryn Melissa Dafoe. I'm warning you. Anyways, let's get back to the story before things get too waffly. We will be joined by the Adamantians, and they have some research planned. Welcome to the Adamantium Society. The club run by Brainiac Adam and his team of heroes. This is where the entitled movie of Karen Dafoe starts. This includes the ghost of Freddie Mercury. It just comes to show how some of our many favourites can still live on forever in our memories. They are currently in a meeting and Adam is handing out assignments to his group.
Now then guys, this is a very important matter. My good friend Darren Stratton is in grave danger of having his universe turned upside down by two entitled little bee snitches, and he's in desperate need of our help. I have asked Lottie if she could help us in aiding in our mission, and she said she'd be happy to help us out anytime.
We are always happy to help in a situation such as Darren's world becoming endangered at being taken over by entitled women. We won't stay still while this world looks likely to succumb to such a monstrosity. Let us know what we need to do, and we'll be on it, no questions asked.
Thank you very much, Freddy. I always knew I could count on my group of heroes. I love you to bits, guys, and I'm honored to have you in my group as help heroes.
Word also has it that the Alanarciums are seeking to join the League of Entitled Karens. Karen Dafoe is teaching them her ways, and they're seeking to make a virus that turns everyone entitled like them. We must do something to stop that from happening.
Oh my goodness! Thanks for the heads up, Jeremy. I must go and see Darren and warn him of what's about to unfold.
It might be a better idea to invite him down here, as it is very important that he knows what's about to unfold in his animated universe.
That's a good point, Rita. We've heard that Darren's been running his animated universe since 2011, and he's come a long way since he's begun. The last thing we want here is to have his hard work wiped out due to that entitled group of people.
Absolutely. The best way to go about this is to research into what's happened within the League of Entitled Karens. Together, we will take them down, once and for all.
However, while I'm taking note of all this, I still think Darren needs another group of people to back him up, apart from us and his family. He is at risk of being ruined. Which one of us should make the phone call to let him know, and to ultimately invite him to come down?
I think I'd better do that, my wondrous strawberry ice cream. Darren's my good friend, and he desperately needs us. What else do you have in mind?
Oh wow, Adam. I've never heard that term of endearment come out of your mouth before. It's totally random.
It's okay, Jeremy. In the DMC neighborhood, all the couples get to call each other using food-related terms of endearment.
It's true, Jeremy. I'll let Adam make the phone call and see if we can bring Darren down here. Once again, it's critical that he knows what's going on with his animated universe.
I'll see you in a bit, Adamantian. I'm just off to make a phone call to Darren, and once I finish, I'll let you know what's going on.
Please do, Adam. We just worry about Darren, especially after all the hard work he's done putting this neighborhood together.
I do hope everything's going to be okay, guys. I just can't help but worry about Darren.
I'm sure he will be fine, Rita. He's managed to take care of things before and came out on top every single time.
But I don't think he's managed anything quite like this before. That's the reason Adam's called us, so that we can help a good friend in need. This catastrophe has turned into something quite major, and Darren needs us.
Meanwhile, at the Hughes household, Adam has tried to contact Darren, but all he gets is a dead tone. Things have already taken a turn for the worse, and Adam is getting worried.
Come on, Darren. Please pick up your phone. I'm getting really worried about you. Let's try and get hold of Sarah and see if she answers.
I'm terribly sorry, Adam. I came here as quickly as I could. I tried to call you earlier, but my phone died. Is it possible that I can charge it, please?
Of course you can, Darren. After I've taken you to the Adamantium Society, we have some critical information to share with you.
Is it something to do with the possible upheaval of my animated universe? It's getting me down hearing about it, and I can feel myself getting further depressed about losing 11 years of hard work.
Absolutely. The Adamantians and I have discovered that my troublesome group are arriving at the DMC neighborhood, and I came personally to try and find you, so that we can arrange to help you take them down.
Oh no, not the Alanastiums. What else can I do about what's to come? This is an absolute disaster.
There's no time to explain it here, Darren. Come on, let's now go down to the Adamantium Society, and we will explain it in more detail.
5 minutes later, and Darren and Adam return back to the Adamantium Society. The remaining members were pleased to see him again after his 1,000 subscriber party.
How about we have some drinks while we try to figure out what's going on? We all need it, especially when trying to talk about the dangers ahead.
That sounds like a great idea, Adam. However, I can't help but worry about my wife and kids. Hopefully, they'll be all right.
They'll be fine, Darren. James is there with Millie and their kids.
Can someone keep my family posted as to what's happening with me, please? They need to know as well.
I can take care of that, Darren. I've written down some notes, so I'll send you back with them, but we are not going to let you go alone, not unless another club is on standby, waiting in the wings to help out wherever they can.
But how am I supposed to go back home if I'm not allowed to go alone?
We're coming with you, Darren. It's important that everyone knows that, one, what is going on at the moment, and two, how we're doing everything we can to protect you from all the dangers that are about to unfold. Our hideout is very well hidden, and we have the strongest security, so not even the strongest hacker can work out the code.
That seems to put my mind at rest, but I'm getting desperate here. If my animated universe really is at risk, what can I do to sort stuff out? This neighborhood needs its main man.
Oh, there, Darren. Come here, come and cry on my shoulder. It's gonna be alright. I'll try my best to understand the main calamity that's at the hand. Adamantium, can you go get me some tissues, please? I'm gonna comfort Darren.
Of course, we can, Adam. It's heartbreaking to see this happening.
Come on, Darren. Let's go outside for a bit. I'll take the best care of you. I'm not going anywhere. You're going to be safe with me.
While Adam is comforting Darren, the rest of the Adamantians are still working out what is going on and how they can save the neighborhood.
I've got to get some research done as to what we could do to save the DMC neighborhood.
Would there be any good news behind Darren's catastrophe?
I really do hope so. The poor soul has been through enough dealing with four of his own troublemakers, without having to deal with a whole army of them. We need to figure out what's happening, and we've no time left to lose.
I've got a few notes written down, so hopefully, the information we give Darren should be able to help him out a bit.
I think someone's coming, and it looks like they are in an urgent rush. Let's see what's going on out there.
Guys, this is getting bad. Darren is quite possibly sobbing uncontrollably. We need to do something to help him.
We'll keep on looking for the answers that will help him.
Thank you, Rita. I always knew I could count on my wonderful group of heroes. In the meantime, I'd better get back to Darren. He needs me, and fast.
Adam, before you go, there are some more tissues in the kitchen. Go and get some for Darren.
Thanks, Freddy. We ran out about 10 minutes ago, and my shoulder is dripping wet. That's because the poor soul hasn't stopped crying.
Oh, the poor soul. I can't believe this is happening, and oh look, the two main characters are leaving one of the shops, so we'd best continue with our research.
No problem, Jeremy. In the meantime, I shall now go back and find Darren. He needs his good friend, and fast.
With that in mind, the rest of the Adamantium set to do some research behind the calamity of the DMC neighborhood. Whilst Adam is comforting Darren, they both notice the events taking place outside the shop. Let's cross over to the shop as things are starting to get very interesting. We're now outside the shop, where we meet the two main entitled people of this movie. Karen Dafoe, aged 25, and her sister Taryn, aged 32. They've been thrown out of the shop because they refused to pay for their £250 food shop and instead demanded that they got it for free. Sorry ladies, but the DMC neighbourhood doesn't work like that.
And how exactly do you know that?
Well, in case you haven't noticed, Karen Stacey Dafoe, but this is called the DMC neighbourhood and I get to call the shots here.
You can just keep telling your sad little bit that piece of disinformation.
Sad little but? I'll have you know that the real me who's narrating this movie is 8 years older than you.
Whatever.
I'm still going to take over the DMC neighborhood, and I've enlisted on some help as well. The Alanosiums are coming soon, with my invitation, and together, we plan to turn this place around, so that everyone will worship us instead of your sad, pathetic little butt.
That's right. We will start with the main family, and then we'll turn everyone else against you. They will soon start acting entitled like Karen, who, by the way, is the most perfect and wholesome sister you could ever ask for. She deserves everything in this world, and I'll stop at nothing until she gets it. Watch my words, Mr. Narrator, this neighborhood will wait on us hand and foot.
You will leave my family alone. If you so much as touch a hair on their shoulders, I'll personally make sure you have hell to pay.
We'll just see about that. Now then, since you're not going to shut up, then I guess we're going to have to make you.
Nice going, sis. Now that annoying whiny little narrator won't bother us anymore.
Ooh, would you look at that? We have some new people coming, and I think they have an invitation for the both of us.
Hey there, I'm Karen McCarrenson, and I brought with me some very special people, my three good friends. You must be the two Dafoe sisters, Karen and Taryn.
We are, indeed, Karen M. We're trying to find a way to take over the DMC neighborhood, and we're not sure as to what to do.
That's where we come into play, Taryn. We have a very special invitation to share with you. I promise you now, you're going to absolutely love this.
That sounds great. If you have any suggestions in mind that will help us in taking over the DMC neighborhood, we'll be open to hearing them.
We would love to induct you into the League of Entitled Karens. We always get what we want, and nothing that we don't. We will make sure that you two always get what you want, and nothing is going to stand in our way.
That sounds amazing. Thank you very much.
Now then, I see you got chucked out of that shop across the road, did you not? We'll go in and take care of this monstrosity for you. No one chucks my good friends out of a shop and expects to get away with it.
Thank you very much, Karen M. You four are lifesavers. We couldn't do this on our own.
Anytime, Taryn. You're one of us now, and things are going to get better from here. You don't need to worry about a thing while you're with us.
So, I'm going to deal with that rather mean shopkeeper for you, and I'll let the other girls take care of you too. I'll catch up once I'm finished. I shouldn't be too long.
Come on, Karen and Taryn Dafoe. We've got some great ideas for you. You see that building over there? That is the mansion where Darren's new club resides. I think we can attack there after we've dealt with the Stryton family. We'll attack the people that are closest to Darren, and then we start to expand out to the whole of this neighborhood.
That sounds like a wonderful plan. Darren thinks he can get away with this commotion, but not on our watches, he can't. On our watches, he'll have to do as we say, or we will banish him to a faraway land where no one will ever find him.
Have we got a secret hideout where we can get our plan sorted and into action?
We have, actually. It's just a few minute walk away. It lies just outside of the DMC neighborhood. We've got everything you could ever ask for, even more than what this lame excuse of a neighborhood has. So, when you're ready, we'll let the main ringleader know what's going on, and then we'll get going too.
Now this is something worth looking into. There has been some case that needs solving and desperate too. However, I am not going to be on my own. I have got three other police officers helping me out with this mission to get to ensure to stop Karen and Taryn Dafoe.
Good morning, Alan. We came as soon as we received your message. Is everything okay?
Things are okay at the moment. Darren needs our help, and far.
What's going on in this neighborhood? Something major must be happening, or we wouldn't have been called.
Darren has kept his animated universe running for 11 years. But Karen and Taryn Dafoe are trying to wipe out the population. Starting with the main leader, he's currently with Adamantia. But they are doing anything as possible to keep him safe. But goodness knows what's gonna happen.
It's a good job you asked us to come along, Alan. It looks like you need help sorting this mess out.
I do, Officer Peter, but I have lost count on how many times we have tracked down Karen and Taryn Dafoe. Too many troublemakers have escaped from his prison.
We will help you keep track of where they end up. But word has it that other people are coming along too, And the League of Entitled Karens are up to something as well.
I read about that in the papers just before we arrived here.
So, Alan, tell us what needs doing, and we will assist you in the best way we can.
I need help in trying to track where the League of Entitled Karens may be hiding. We will be able to assist them when they get to where they are.
That, Alan, is going to be easier said than done. They left the main area, and we can't track the areas outside the DMC neighborhood.
Say, officers, have you noticed something quite off with this part of the movie?
Yes, the narrator hasn't introduced the scene like he usually does.
This could only mean one thing. Officers!
That's right. The League of Entitled Karens are already at work. Karen Dafoe went through with her threat and shoved size 13 socks into the mouth of our narrator, and now he can't tell the viewers at home what's going on. We'd better find a way to stop them, as things are getting desperate here, and with no way of being kept up to date, things are only said to get worse.
Oh dear, you may be right there, Officer Peter. There is another update on our radar screen.
The same update has just popped up on my pager. We've got no time to waste.
And with imminent danger approaching, we need to get this sorted, and desperately.
You know the one thing that worries me, Alan?
What's that, Officer Geraint?
All this drama is going to drive Darren away from the DMC neighborhood. I just can't help but worry about him. And this worry eats at me.
It's okay, Officer Jerry. We will get this sorted once and for all. You poor soul. Come on. Let's go out for a bit.
I'm not sure at the moment, Officer Susan. I just can't help but worry about Darren. He's the main man of this neighborhood. And the DMC neighborhood without him is like warm ice cream soup.
Or like honeycomb without its sweetness.
Or like Brainiac without the abusive science experiment. Oh my goodness. It's only Brainiac Adam. The one and only, I've come to assist you in taking down Karen and the rest of her troublemakers. I have some very useful information for you guys. The rest of my crew are back inside our den, and I want Darren back home, where his family will do their best to comfort him.
That is a great idea, Adam. Can I ask you to keep a close eye on him, because who knows where the Karens might be, and we are desperate for to know where the Karens are.
Of course I can, Alan. You can count on me with that.
I knew I could always count on you, Adam.
No problem, Alan. Now then, with that being said, I'm now going to get back to Darren and Sarah. They need me there. Adam, is it possible for you to take me along, please? I want to team up with you and the Adamantians and helping you protect Darren. Of course I can, Officer Geraint. Come on, let's get going and help Darren take down the League of Entitled Karens. I'm coming right behind you, Adam. We're off to come for Darren and make him as safe as can be.
And now we're down to three. Let's continue to find ways to track down the Karens and so we can get this world back to peace.
We're on it, right away, Alan. Can I also make another suggestion, please?
Of course you can, Officer Susan. What do you have in mind?
You may want to add even more maximum security prison cells, with tightened measures to ensure that they can never escape from here again.
That sounds like a good idea, Officer Susan. I'll call and see if we can get an extension into the prison.
That sounds like an idea. Let's get to that, straight away.
It's official, guys! The narrator has returned, and now we can get on with keeping you viewers at home up to date with what's going on. This is the part where the drama really starts to unfold. The DMC neighborhood is no longer a safe haven because a group of evil...
I thought I stuffed 15 size 13 socks into your mouth. How did you manage to get them all out? You must have had help, didn't you? Are you going to tell me how you got the socks out of your mouth?
Or are we going to have to take some more drastic measures to keep you out of this movie forever? This is called the entitled movie of Karen Dafoe, not Darren Stratton, the movie.
I beg your pardon? Did you just use that title to slander my own movie, which was released before this one? I don't believe you, Karen Melissa Dafoe. You are so bloody unreal.
Well, that would be telling, and a girl of success never shares her secrets.
Answer my question right now, you self-entitled little wretch.
No. Now you either get lost, or you will be the first to get zapped with our entitled potion once we brewed it. Your choice, Adam, but I wouldn't waste my time if I were you.
Well, you'll just have to keep on waiting then. Now, I have someone to protect. So either you get out of my way, or I'll give you such a brainiac-style punishment day. And that you'll wish you were an object. I'm warning you, you pair of his self-entitled snitch baskets, get out of my way right now.
Well, well, well. Look at who we've got here trying to stand in our way.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not going to hang around here and listen to your sad, pathetic little asses. I'm getting out of here because I've been tasked with something very important, and I'm not about to let you group of entitled B-snitches get in my way. So I'll tell you once again, get out of my way!
Did you just insult us, Adam? That's it. You're going to get your just desserts.
Oh, no thanks. I just had my favorite type of dessert, a Ferrero Rocher ice cream topped with the finest hazelnuts and blue raspberry sprinkles. Now, for the third time, get out of my bloody way! I won't tell you again! What's going on here? Adam, you go and take care of Darren. You've done well so far. Let me take it from here. Okay, Officer Geraint, I'll head off now, but I'll tell you something. The League of Entitled Karens will get it from me eventually. You just watch. Now then, I don't want to have to break up another fight between you and lots of innocent citizens in this neighborhood.
Fine. You may have won this time, but we are going to team up with some special friends of ours, and we will take over this neighborhood. You just watch us. The DMC neighborhood belongs to me. Me, I tell you. And I'll stop at nothing until I get to claim what is rightfully mine.
Exactly. And we will stop at nothing until we succeed in having the deeds transfer into your name.
And no amounts of law-abiding will keep us at bay either. You're going to get this, all of you. We'll stop at nothing until we get what we want, and what we want is to drive Darren Stratton out of the DMC neighborhood and rid everyone of that crybaby. After that, we will transfer the deeds over to Karen Dafoe, because she deserves it more than that loser of a crybaby does.
That's right. And if you try and intervene with our genius plans, we will find you and give you hell to pay. You just watch yourself and go back home to your mummy, like the naughty little boy you are.
That's it. I'm going to have to need some backup. These Karens are getting too much for me to bear on my own. Brainiac Adam for the rescue. Did I just hear you correctly? Did you just insult one of my police officers? I swear, you are going to get it. Come on, Officer Geraint. Let's get out of here. I'll bring in some more enforcement. We're going to need it, and fast.
You think you can win? Well, not if I have something to say about it, you won't. We will take down this whole neighborhood, and I then get to claim it as my very own. You will not hear the last of Karen Dafoe, especially not once I get rid of Darren. I will be welcomed in here like a proper hero.
Come on, ladies. Let's go back to our shelter. That officer has just crossed the line with us. We will make sure that everyone has hell to pay when we've finished off what we have planned.
Come on, Officer Geraint, let's get out of here. And as for you, troublesome lot, I hope you're satisfied with yourself. You will get it. You just watch our space. I'm right behind you, Adam. I was so close to swearing before you came along and saved my skin. How could I ever thank you? Don't worry about it, Officer Geraint. We're always here to stick up for each other. I mean, after all, Alan Dewberry has invited you to come here so we can have some more law enforcement here in the DMC neighborhood. He most certainly did. Come on, let's go and get Darren, and then we should have a drink to take our minds off what has just happened. I'll tell you, this is just the beginning of the trouble. I dread to think what is going to happen next.
Same here. We need to be more vigilant when it comes to taking down members of the League of Entitled Karens. I've got some ideas up my sleeve, but most of them are based on my favorite science show.
Oh, I did not know you used to watch Brainiac Science Abuse.
Of course I did, Officer Geraint, and I absolutely loved it. So much that I decided to name myself Brainiac Adam on YouTube.
That's true, guys. Adam told me that as we were traveling to Dinas Romver in a DMC Annually episode. Anyway, as we leave Brainiac Adam and Officer Geraint behind, we have even more trouble starting to stir up in the DMC neighborhood. And it's down to the citizens to try and keep them at bay, but the strain is starting to show there too. We're now back at the park where we were first introduced to the entitled movie of Karen Dafoe. Things start off nice and relaxed until a new broadcast on the radio stops everything dead in their tracks. The Prime Minister, who was recruited to the Alanastiums, had taken to the stand to deliver some potentially chilling news.
Good morning. Well, I don't know if it will be a good morning for you, but it will certainly be a good one for us. We have a neighbourhood warning to issue with you with. We are going to come down the DMZ neighbourhood, and that's myself and the Alanastiums. We are going to help a certain lady take it all over and claim it as hers.
Bojo continues talking for another 10 minutes, unravelling all the plans that the Alanastiums had made prior to the newscast. This was until James turns off the radio.
I don't believe this. He clearly shouldn't be allowed to get away with this racket.
It's too much for words, Dad. I mean, wasn't he the one who told us to stay at home, cancelled Christmas for those in times of desperate need, and then went out to party himself? I'd say this Prime Minister, if we can call him that, is an absolute first-class hypocrite.
Normally, Lily, I would ask you to watch your mouth, but I'm going to let you have that one.
Thanks, Dad. I only seek to speak the truth, and this sort of thing really oils my chains.
This sort of thing oils my chains too, my sweetie. And particularly when Darren is in danger of having 11 years of hard work going down the chute.
It really worries me, my pineapple ice cream cone. I'm still struggling to work out what we're supposed to do to protect Darren from this mess.
Come on. Let's go and get some ideas sorted. We need to help Darren and fast.
Too late, girls. The Alanastiums have now arrived, so you better take cover and fast.
What is this place we've ended up in? It looks incredibly dull and boring.
Maybe, perhaps. This is what Karen Dafoe was talking about when she said that this neighborhood was boring and bland.
I will tell you something that might cheer this place on.
What would you think would help in a situation such as this, Wario? I know your parents aren't here, so you can cause as big a riot as you please.
Alan Huntington in the house, and oh my goodness, this place looks terrible. Let us get out of here and look for the League of Entitled Karens. That is the reason we came here in the first place.
Oh, look what the cat dragged in. It's the bloody pathetic excuse of a person who deemed it appropriate to push a baby downhill in one of my videos. What have you got to say for yourself, Alan? Well, come on. I'm waiting for an answer, and I want it right now.
Oh, if it is only the person who claims to be a brainiac when he needs to work at that strawberry field in Cardiff.
You will leave the strawberry field out of this, Alan. That place is evil and horrible. Darren went there once, and none of the staff said a single thing to him.
Well, of course you are going to stick up for that useless piece of junk. You always do.
That useless piece of junk? I'll have you know that that happens to be my good friend you just insulted. Now then, you will get out of my way, and you will do that right now.
Hi Adam, I wondered what the noise was all about, and, oh my goodness, it's the Alanastiums.
The one and only group, and we are here to take you down.
That's my line you stole there, Quan Chi. Never do that again. Do I make myself clear?
Well, it is only Green Yakanon. He is ultimately scared of me.
Nice try, you green little two-faced monster. I might have been scared of you before, but not anymore. I've learned to face my fears when it comes to terrible little wimps like you.
Come on, guys. Let's get out of here. I can't stand this drama much longer.
Well then, see what you make of this.
Now that was uncalled for. Why the hell did you do that for?
Because I can. Now then, it is time for us to claim our prize and take them to the League of Entitled Karens. They will be thrilled when we tell them what we have done.
I can't believe they did that. I may no longer be scared of the mask, but what he did to Darren is totally unforgivable. I need to call my crew, and I need to work out some strategies. Oh, what's going on here, Adam? Is everything okay?
No.
Billy. The Alanazis have arrived, and they've kidnapped Darren. This happened so fast that I barely had any time to react.
Come here, Adam. Let me give you a hug.
We've got to do something about this, Dad. Things are getting pretty desperate here, and I just can't take it anymore.
I'm sure we'll think of something, my sweetness.
I appreciate your concerns, Rainsgate, but I think I'd better take some time out. I need to call Lottie too. This is where I really need her.
I hope Adam cheers up soon. It hurts to see him down.
Oh, I hope so too. In the meantime, we better get ourselves prepared. The main person has been kidnapped, and we need to try and work out what's going on.
Meanwhile, back in the Hughes household, Adam has pondered over the kidnapping of Darren. He calls the real random Lozzie for some guidance on what to do.
Hi, Lozzie. It's Brainiac Adam here. I need your help, and fast.
What's wrong, Adam? Have you been crying?
I have, actually. The Alanassians have arrived at the DMC neighborhood, and they kidnapped Darren. I feel like I've let his family down because I didn't save him in time.
Adam, it's not your fault. You couldn't have done anything about it. Hold on, I'm coming over.
Thanks, Lozzie. I really need your help.
Don't worry, Adam. You did the best you could.
My good friend is gone, and I feel like I've been something missing.
Oh dear, this has gotten bad. I'm not quite sure what to do here.
The best thing you can do is to comfort Adam until Lozzie arrives.
I agree with you, Rita. We'll get this sorted, once and for all. In the meantime, Lozzie should be on her way over.
That would be brilliant if she did. I really need her.
Freddy, I'll take over from here. I'll look after Adam until Lozzie arrives. Maybe, she'll call the rest of the YouTube Alliance into a meeting.
That way, we'll all be able to get Darren back to where he rightfully belongs.
With that in mind, the rest of the Adamantians set off to mark the plans of rescuing Darren. They left Sabrina behind as she is comforting a very upset Brainiac Adam. Lozzie is aware of what's going on, and she's getting some assignments ready for the YouTube Alliance. We now cross over to the YouTube Alliance, where the number currently stands at 31. More people are set to join them as well. The main leader, the real random Lozzie, just finished on the phone to Brainiac Adam, and with the news that Darren was kidnapped and hit with a silencing spell, she starts to hand out assignments to the group. Brainiac Adam is still at home at the moment, trying to figure out how to rescue Darren.
Now then, guys. This is a very serious matter. Darren's been kidnapped and was taken to the League of Entitled Karens. We need to be careful because Karen McCarran's son is in charge. Some careful planning and strategic research need to take place if we're to stand a chance against the League of Entitled Karens.
What would you like us to do, Lozzie? Tell us what you'd like us to do, and we'll assist you, no worries or questions.
Would you be able to lead the strategic research, Daniel? I think I've got some great ideas up my sleeves. I'm also going to call Boris and Doris. Caillou may have some ideas too, and he might be able to assist us.
That will be a great idea, Lozzie. I heard he's been getting a lot of high scores for his work, and I can't help but think that the Anderson family need a new beginning.
I agree with you, Lachlan. Now then, we'll get the organization of our rescue of Darren sorted, and then I'll call Brainiac Adam.
Or I could come to you, Lozzie. Tell me what needs to be done, and I'll happily assist whenever I'm needed.
Hey, Adam. It's great to see you again. It's also great to see you're back to your usual self.
Well, Lozzie, I can't be too much of a hero if I wallow too much in self-pity. Come on, we have a sweet soul to save. He's also the main ringleader of the DMC neighborhood, and he needs us, and fast.
We are on your side, Adam. We will do everything to save Darren. Karen Dafoe will get what's coming to her, eventually.
Well, I have a punishment day planned for all of the League of Entitled Karens, and since this one is based on my favorite science show, I'm gonna make it Brainiac style. After all, I'm Brainiac Adam, the one and only.
Wow. What a line, Adam. How did you manage to get that epic of a line assigned to you?
Darren used it for the first time we met. Even our real life selves have used it in our videos. Now then, where did we get to? Oh, that's right. Darren needs our help. and fast.
Say, Adam, we have a whole ton of details to give you. This will help you in many ways.
Whatever it is, let me know, and I'll happily assist in whichever way I can.
If you want, John Aquia and I can set up some detours around their den. John Aquia shared some designs with me earlier, and I have to say, they look rather legendary.
That's right. One of the detours I made involves a rather strong smell of a skunk. Anyone that walks over it won't know what's hit them.
And believe me, that's just the start of things. John Aquia showed me some other ideas, and they've had a lot of hard work put into them.
Really? Thank you very much, James. That's so very sweet of you to say that.
I mean it too, John Aquia. You really do have some talents there. They will come in very handy when it comes to rescuing Darren, and ultimately take down the League of Entitled Karens.
That sounds like a brilliant idea, James. I'll get to working on them right away.
Darren's been bound by some sticky tape, which is supposed to bind like glue. I think I might have worked something out.
What's that, Lucy? I think this is going to be something good that's about to unfold. I'm looking forward to hearing this.
Well, with every trap comes a weakness, and whilst we've been helping Jonika with some of her traps, we tried and tested them on some dummies that I made. With that being said, we then tweaked every trap to ensure that the weaknesses are not exposed. The sticky tape that binds Darren. It has a weakness to heat.
Are you thinking what I am, Lucy? You have the rapid hair dryer, have you not? Maybe we could find a way to distract everyone in the League of Entitled Karens.
And we can use Lucy's hair dryer to free Darren. Lucy, you're an absolute legend.
After that, we can put Darren and his family into the safe hotel. This will keep him safe from any other dangers that he might face.
But then, if Darren wants to help us, we should let him. However, there are other families that are willing to help us too. You can certainly count on the baritones as well as the Rainskates.
Would you like me to call Geraint Rainskate? I'm good friends with him, and sometimes I look after his kids. We have some great ideas on the go.
Jamie and I will conduct some valuable research, and we'll share the results with you when we've finished.
Absolutely! Come on. Let's go and get the necessary research into how we can take that entitled club down.
How would you like to have some food? I'm a really good cook, and I would like to share my creations with you. How does that sound?
That sounds great, Aiden. I look forward to trying your food. So, when you're ready, my apple peach surprise, we will get cooking some lunch.
Absolutely, my mango cherry chutney. We will get to that right away.
Say, Lazy. What would you like me to do?
Anything you want us to do, and we'll get on it right away.
Would you two be able to help Jenica with the effective working on her deters, please? This will ensure maximum effectiveness when it comes to taking down the League of Entitled Karens.
Not forgetting to mention my troublemaking group of Alanastiums. You just wait till I get my hands on the lot of them. Especially that Bojo character. I swear, he is getting worse by the second. Feeding the nation of a whole load of disinformation. I don't know how he thinks that he can even get away with such a mess like this.
What's the difference between the two terms?
Disinformation is wrong information given on a deliberate scale, whereas misinformation is accidental.
I would like to help as well. Darren's my best friend, and I'll stop at nothing until he's back to where he should be.
You'll be with me and the Adamantians, James. Together, there's nothing that'll stop us.
Thanks, Adam. I'll stop at nothing to save my best friend from those two evil groups.
There is a certain feel of jubilee that will come once the rightful owner of this neighborhood returns.
Absolutely. Come on, James and Adam. We'll go get ourselves prepared and set up any data that journey come back.
But before we do that, I need to hold another meeting with my group of Adamantians. It's important that they know what's going on, so that they'll be able to give us a helping hand in taking those two groups down.
With that Bojo character spewing out disinformation like that, I swear he should be making videos for 5-minute crofts, or even Bright Side. Then again, they're both managed by the Soul Publishing, and their headquarters are based in Russia.
I used to be subscribed to Bright Side, until Darren warned me of the disinformation that was coming off the channel.
What did he say to you in the end, James?
Ultimately, he said that Brightside were owned by The Soul Publishing, who own over 200 channels on YouTube, including 5-Minute Crafts, who tell you to put strawberries into bleach to make them white.
Oh my goodness. Darren's a very wise man to steer you away from that company. I watched a video once on Brightside, where it said that a human can break free from a spider's web by wriggling out of their clothes.
I watched that same video too. That was the very first bit that Darren debunked, and rightfully too, I must add. We're too heavy to even get trapped inside a spider's web. They're used for catching insects, not human beings.
Going back to the bleached strawberries. That clip has now been edited out of every video it featured in. Rightfully too, I must add. It's incredibly dangerous and can poison you if you eat them.
It is always nice to know that something will come out of our meeting. However, we need to save Darren, and we are running out of time.
You're right, Francisco. Let's get our head back in the plan of saving Darren.
Lunch is served, everyone, although I do seem to notice that a few people are now missing.
That's all right, my saucy peach toffee. Adam's gone off to hold a second meeting with the Adamantians. He's going to uncover the ideas that everyone came up with.
The lunch looks delicious, Aiden. Thank you very much.
No worries, John Aquia. Let's get eating and having a great time.
So, while the YouTube Alliance are having their lunch, I'm pleased to announce that there are some plans that are coming into place to save Darren from the League of Entitled Karens and the Alanastians. Let's now cross back over to the Adamantians and see what plans they have uncovered. We are now back inside the den of the Adamantians. Adam has cooked up some pizza and chips, and whilst they're eating, they're also making notes as to what came out of the meeting held with the YouTube Alliance. Adam reveals that every trap has its weakness, but it doesn't stop him from making something new to dish up on those two evil groups.
I managed to get some useful information out of this meeting I attended with the YouTube Alliance, and while every trap has its weakness, Jonika has built some rather unique traps. One which acts like a skunk, it triggers off a smell of unlimited number of times, but when they are tweaked, they're so that they don't go off whenever we go in, and whenever Darren comes out.
That sounds like a brilliant idea, Adam. It's always nice to see when plans come into play. I've also taken some notes down as well. It's noted that the den is made out of aluminium and glass. Haven't we got some metal cutters in our toolbox that can cut aluminium? We also have some that can shred aluminium like it's just paper.
And I've also tweaked my trustworthy Hoover so that it can suck human beings like no business. That sounds like something worth testing out, but what shall I use it on first?
I've got a human-sized dummy upstairs if you wish to use that. It doesn't matter. I can always make another one if I need to.
That sounds great, Princess Peach. Thank you very much.
That's not a problem, Freddy. So, how about after lunch, we get your updated Hoover tested?
That sounds like a brilliant idea, Princess Peach. I'll be able to make short work of this, I'm absolutely sure of it.
I think I might have an idea too, Adam. How about I make a series of magnets with only one of the poles? That way, we can make the door repel the Alanistans away from the den of the League of Entitled Karens.
That sounds like a good idea, Rita, but I think Karen Dafoe has a countermeasure put in place, so I don't think these magnets stick too well to aluminium either. However, we'll keep it in the pipeline, because I reckon that after a bit of tweaking, that idea will become sensational.
That's fair enough, Adam. I'll keep on trying until I can find a sensible idea to repel all evil out of the DMC neighborhood.
I better get that. It sounds like a rather important call.
I have a funny idea who it might be. Adam has brought three officers into the DMC neighborhood, with the approval of Alan Dewberry. It might be one of Adam's officers.
I would like to introduce you to one of my police officers. This is Officer Geraint, and I've invited him to our meeting, and so that he can offer us some assistance to what is going on here. Vaughn, what a pleasure it is to see you all. This could be some claim to fame. I finally get to meet my favorite group of heroes.
It's great to see you, Officer Geraint.
Oh, it's great to see you, Jeremy Corbyn. I was wondering if I could have something to eat, please. My stomach is growling like an angry bear. Of course you can, officer. I cooked up some pizza and chips about 5 minutes ago, and it's still very much fresh and hot. Grab yourself a plate and have as much as you want. Oh, thanks, Adam. Oh, I have to tell you, being a police officer isn't easy work, and it's not a wise idea to be doing your duties on an empty stomach. If you want, I can put up some by the other officers. You're absolutely right. You officers are always going to need your fuel after all. And I think, in fact, that I know that I'll be the right man for making sure to feed my hard-working police officers. So that'll be brilliant, Adam. I'll be sure to let them know about your kindness and generous offer. So, what did I miss earlier? I arrived late because I was working on research of Alan earlier.
We were discussing ways of helping Jenica with some traps on how to get rid of those two evil groups.
I thought of the idea of one pearl magnets, but now I realize this might not be a good idea. I mean, it's not easy trying to break a magnet into two parts, particularly not the one I had in mind.
And I've tweaked about with my trustworthy Hoover, and I'm just about to try it out on one of Princess Peach's human-sized dummies. After we've done that, I add further tweaks. This is to ensure that we can have maximum efficiency with it picking up normal bits, as well as humans when needed.
So, when you're ready, Freddy, let's now put your updated Hoover to the test.
I'm right behind you, Princess Peach.
Say, Adam, how about we take the lunches to the other police officers? We've got some very useful information to share with them on how we're going to save this neighborhood.
The remaining members of the Adamantiums were sharing information with Officer Garrine, when suddenly, an alarm rings which makes Brainiac Adam jump in panic.
Bloody hell! Who the hell has managed to find out the secret in combination to my house? Spare me, guys. I better see what is going on. I'll come with you, Adam. I'll be able to give that person what for. Thanks, Scout Officer. I think I'll benefit from the backup.
I just hope that things get themselves sorted soon, and that Adam works out who's broken into his house.
I hope so too, Tame. It's very annoying when something like that happens. I mean, goodness knows what would have happened if that person was able to infiltrate our den.
I doubt they'd be able to, only we know the secret combination to this hideout, and it requires certain books to be pulled back. These books refuse to budge for any unauthorized intruders. They can automatically tell the difference between who's an adamantium, and who's an intruder, but they'll also let our friends come in too.
Which explains as to why it let Darren and Adam's police officer in. I say that because none of us here can pronounce his name correctly.
It's Officer Garrine, Sabrina. And speaking of Officer Garrine, he and Brainiac Adam are back inside the main area of the Hughes household. And Adam was able to work out who entered his house. And believe me, he is not impressed. In fact, he is so annoyed that he swears rather strongly during this encounter.
Oh, my goodness. What a rather glamorous place I ended up in. Maybe I might be able to go downstairs and...
Oh, it's only the mask. The two-faced, green-faced monster who scared me as a child. Just what in all kinds of fuck are you doing in my house? And how the hell did you manage to work out the combination to my front door? You are so bloody unreal, Mask. I can't believe you did that.
Well, that would be telling. And I certainly will not be telling you. Not after the way you swore at me.
And you think he didn't have the right to? You broke into my house, and now you're going to answer to Brainiac Adam. What made you deem it appropriate to break into his house?
Well, if I refuse to answer to Brainiac Adam, I certainly will not be answering to you either.
Either you answer our question, or I'll make sure you'll never have the chance to speak to me or anyone else inside this neighborhood ever again. Come on, I haven't got all day.
Well, you are going to have to wait, because I refuse to answer, unless you apologize to me for swearing.
Wait. Let's retract on that. You want me to apologize for swearing at you, after you deemed it appropriate to break into my house? Why? Cheeky little fucker! I don't believe you! Officer, I'm off to get some water, because I feel faint from all that shouting. And when I get back, I'm going to do something to that horrible green-faced monster. Before I head off, I'm going to glue his feet to the floor so he can't move.
Brainiac Adam glues the feet of the mask to the floor. This is to ensure that he can't move. He then goes into the kitchen to find the biggest glass he has and starts to pour tap water. He is still very annoyed at this point. In fact, he is so annoyed that Officer Geraint can hear him muttering to himself.
Well, if anyone has the cheek of just breaking into my house and demands that I apologise to them for swearing, then that's just completely beyond my understanding. I doubt myself sometimes as to why I'm even doing what I am doing at times like this. My goodness. I haven't muttered this hard since TFW went horribly wrong, and Darren and I were stranded in port for over an hour. This is really oiling my chains. I've got to find a way out, to take down that two-faced monster before he has the chance to penetrate my brain. Come on, Adam. Try to calm yourself down, please. We've got an upheaval inside your house, and muttering like that won't solve the situation.
I'll be all right, officer. But I'll feel a lot better once I take down that horrible slimy little fuckball.
Wait! That gives me an idea!
What's that, Adam? Is it another one of your brainiac moments?
The mouse has got his feet glued to the floor, has he not?
He certainly has. And oh, would you look at that? The more he's struggling, the more he's melting away.
Oh, wow! Now this, I've got to see! I want to see that horrible little slime ball melt before my very eyes. Then maybe, just maybe, the world will be a much better place.
And sure enough, that slimy little two-faced monster melted and melted until he was no more. Brainiac Adam jumped for joy as he witnessed this happening.
And now, this is worth celebrating with some champagne.
Champagne! Champagne for everyone!
Indeed it is. The Alan Ashtons are now down to 7. And things are only going to get better from here.
Let's go to the shop and pick up a bottle of Dom Perignon.
We now go over to the hideout of the League of Entitled Karens. And Karen and Taron Dafoe are enjoying themselves in the hideout. Apparently, this den has so much more to offer than the DMC neighbourhood could ever try to. But Sank tells me that this is a whole pile of rubbish. In the corner stands a muted Darren Stratton. Karen and Taron have bound him up with tape and have completely ruined him. However, little do they realise help is around the corner for Darren.
Now then, ladies. We have some very important things to take care of.
Absolutely, Karen D. We have everything put in place, so that no one, not even his royal centerpiece, can interfere with our plans.
We already have some great ideas put into place, and things are getting ever closer to being yours.
For goodness sake, Darren James Stratton. Shut that mouth of yours, otherwise I'll come over there and make you wish you'd never been born.
Absolutely. I thought the mask had placed a silencing spell on you.
He certainly did, but when he melted into a sludge of slime on my lounge floor, the spell had weakened, and sooner or later, Darren will be able to speak again.
Exactly. And since Darren's a much smarter person than any of you, he will end up breaking out of the tape that you bound him up with.
That masking tape you used on him! I can't believe you did that, you manipulative little moo cow! What the bloody hell has gotten into your cotton-picking mind? I've already dropped 3 F-bombs, so I suggest you get out of here before I end up saying any more in front of them.
And I suggest you get out of here too, before I say something else. Something so foul that not even the real Darren would go down that route of putting it in.
Now that is worth noting, but I'm not budging. You can't make me either, as this is my neighborhood now, and with Darren Stratton bound up and unable to move.
You would hope that I would just give up the will to live? Well, think again, ladies, because I'm regaining my strength, and I'm not about to let a group of self-entitled little moo cows defeat me. I'll have you know that the D part of DMC stands for Darren's, and not Dafoe's. Now then, where is some relief to the masking tape that's binding me?
Now then, listen to me, and listen to me good.
If you think I'm going to just stand here and let you insult and torment Darren like that, you've got another think coming.
And who exactly are you? I don't remember seeing your face around here. Also, you'd better get yourself out of here, because this is our den, and the DMC neighborhood now belongs to me, and only I'm allowed in here with my friends. Get out of here, or I'll call the police.
Go ahead. Call the police. I'll tell them how you deemed it appropriate to torment and try and murder my son.
Of course, you're going to stick up for that useless piece of junk, aren't you?
Did you hear me, Taryn Melissa Dafoe? Or are you as every bit deaf as you are stupid? That's my son you've got gagged up there, so you either let him down, or else you will have hell to pay.
That, you will indeed. Now then, you are going to let Darren down from being bound by that tape, otherwise, I'll do it myself. And since masking tape causes no problems for my special hair dryer, I can have Darren down in a flash.
That you will, and no mistaking it either. So, you either free Darren, or Lucy will do it, and no questions asked.
And everyone in the YouTube Alliance will swoop in to save the day.
Absolutely. Now then, you will either free Darren, and do it now, or Lucy will do it, and we'll give you hell to pay.
Not forgetting to mention, the mask is now a toxic sludge all over my lounge floor. So you Alanasians are now reduced to 7, and this number is about to become 6.
What do you plan to do to our number this time? How would you reduce us when we are still strong in numbers?
Strong in numbers? No. Strong in smell? Yes. My goodness. When was the last time you Alanasiums took a bath? You could all do with a round of soap and water. Oh water, oh water, I'm terribly thirsty. May I please have some water?
That bath is not yours. I don't believe you, James. How could you say that to us?
Quite easily, you ignorant first-class hypocrite. My brain cues up the words I want to say, and then I open my mouth and speak the words.
You just wait, James. I'm going to see you for that piece of cheek. You're not going anywhere near James, you self-centered little fuckface. Now then, because you've deemed it appropriate to threaten Darren's best friend, here is what I'm going to do to you.
Why the hell did you do that for, Adam? That is our Prime Minister. You have just turned into an ice sculpture.
He's not our Prime Minister for much longer. He's just an ice sculpture. And I'm going to stick him out in the nice hot sun. And then all my friends and the Adamantians are going to stand there and watch him melt.
Oh, Adam. That sounds like a brilliant idea.
Now then, since you refuse to free Daron, I guess I'm going to have to.
I'll continue to give the League of Internal Currents and the remaining 6 members of the Alanastiums utter hell that they deserve.
And that is where you can think again, Lachlan. I will not stand here and let you take any more members down.
Come on, League of Entitled Currents. Let's get to taking everyone down.
Leona Louise and Lolly to Pauline Lomax. How did you manage to get inside this den?
We had special invitations from Karen Defoe, and now we're going to defend everyone else that remains.
Well, nice try, you two. I'm going to be taking you back to your parent. You need to be kind home because a war is about to be breaking out, so...
If you two don't mind, you're coming back with us, to the safety of your own home.
Now then, I think we'd better have the safe hotel put in place, and we'll call up a meeting in total safety, and no harm can befall any of us.
Absolutely! So when you're ready, Lozzy, let's go, now!
Come on, Darren. Let's go and take you back to our den. You will be kept safe with us until Adam and Lozzy get the safe hotel organized.
Thanks, Rita. I'll be on it, right away.
Meanwhile, back in the police station, Alan Dubry enlists on some more law enforcement to help take down the remaining members of the Alanastiums and the League of Entitled Karens. He's also run a building company, and with a grant of over £2 million, he was able to build 50 corporate security prison cells with no padlock, so that no one can break out. And now Taryn Defoe can no longer use the protruding key from her shoe.
There you go, that should take care of things. If Karen and Taryn Defoe and the rest of the League of Entitled Karens can think they can be tough, well, we can fight fire with fire.
We've got 50 foolproof prison cells installed in this prison,
Now that we can rejoin the battle with those who remain, the mask has melted into a toxic sludge in Adam's house, so we need to get that sorted as well.
And Lucy, the CBC kid, was able to free Darren.
But who else are we going to call to help us? We are four in number, and two members of the Alanisteams have met their match. The mask is melted into a sludge, and Bojo has been turned into an ice sculpture. Ooh, have you seen the temperature outside?
Officers Peter and Garine checked the report, and indeed it was set to go up to 35 degrees in the shade, and 40 degrees outside.
Oh, Bojo's not going to stand a chance in this heat. It's 40 degrees Celsius outside, the hottest day recorded in Cardiff.
You know what that means then, Officer Garon?
Ice cream! Ice cream for everyone!
I can actually start to see some water dripping off Icy Bojo, so I reckon in the next 3-4 hours, he'll be completely melted, and the sun will dry up all the water.
Now this, I got to say. You know what, we should make this as a campaign to be Prime Minister of the United Kingdom.
Hopefully, it'll be something who won't let us down. We've had Mr. Egg, well, that's what Alexander Orlov called him anyway, and we had David Cameron, who resigned over the news of Brexit. And we had Theresa May, who may have been a lady but didn't do too much. And then we had Bojo, that self-centered little twit teacher, who told us to stay at home, cancel Christmas for millions, and then we went out and partied. What sort of Prime Minister would do that?
I know another thing that may force the Alanisteams to rethink their strategies. It'll be the same thing I do for Wario.
I'll call their families, and I'll come and escort both Alan and Wario out of the DMC neighborhood. Let's see what the Alanisteams will think of that. However, the League of Entitled Karens are trying to recruit the Lomax daughters into their club with the demise of two of the Alanisteams.
We need to put a stop to that and on the double. I don't know why they would do such a thing.
Probably because they like to get a kick out of being naughty.
Maybe, but we can only see what happens from here.
Hi officers, my name is Viley. And even though I can be a troublemaker, I would actually like to assist you in helping to rescue Darren. If you want, I will try and reason with the Lomax daughters as well. They would make great assets to the team I've got planned.
Would you like to help Adam and Lottie in building a safe hotel, Lily? It'll be used to protect all miners and those who are sensitive to danger. Adam and Lottie will hold a meeting, which allows anyone the chance to help out.
Also, if you are able to assist us, we will remove troublemaking from your... police break.
That'll be great, Alan. Tell me what needs to be done, and I'll only be happy to assist. Oh wait, I've got a brilliant idea, officers.
What exactly do you have in mind, Viley?
Well, I'm normally a troublemaker, so I will carry on being a troublemaker, but I'll cause trouble against that precious League of Entitled Karens. Let's see how they'll match against the troublemaking ways of Viley Anderson. And, if Leona and Lolita refuse to see error in their ways, well, it's their loss and our gain.
So, you're planning to cause trouble against the troublemakers? Well, I can help you with that. But first off, can you go and see the making of the safe hotel? Please, the sooner we can protect Darren, the better our chances of taking down those entitled troublemakers.
I'm on it, right away. However, if Darren wishes to help us, then we should really let him. After all, it is his neighborhood we're saving here.
Absolutely, Viley. Now then, can we be able to take you down to a safe hotel?
Yes, please, Alan. I wouldn't even have a clue as to where it is.
Come with me and I'll see you there now. And also, one day, if we ever get a chance to go back to Adelaide, I should be able to give you two tickets to go see the Adelaide Crows play against Collingwood at Adelaide.
And now we're down to three. Hopefully we'll get somewhere with this. I'll get us some ice cream and then we'll get the help with the safe hotel.
After that, we can carry out the work on the extension to this prison. We've some corporate prison cells that need to be filled up.
We need to increase our punishment day scheme.
Upgrade it to a punishment week, or maybe even a punishment month. That'll set the record straight.
I'll get some more research, and then we'll help with the safe hotel.
And that's exactly what the three police officers did. And the research turned up some very conclusive results. Now, because the safe hotel is buried 200 feet underground, Adam and Lottie made sure to install plenteous amounts of air conditioning and also made sure to include all the activities that are needed, including an all-new research lab for any new ideas that may arise. Here we are inside the reception area of the Safe Hotel, and the final building design stretches down to 200 feet underground. And because it is underground, there is plenty of air conditioning inserted inside it, and there are automatic lights that power on when needed. They also have a auto shut-off function, meaning that if a room is empty for more than 30 seconds, the lights will automatically shut off. The door is situated behind the Adamantium's den, and James and Darren are the first two to enter.
Welcome to the all-new Safe Hotel, Darren. It only seemed fitting that I'd be the first to introduce you. After all, you're my best friend.
I couldn't have asked for a better person, James.
I've informed your family as well, and they're on their way over. Mind you, I told them this news about an hour ago, and they still haven't arrived yet.
Do you think they were intercepted by the League of Entitled Karens?
I'm not sure, brother. Maybe I should give Sarah a call.
Oh, Sarah, my pineapple pizza bake. It's wonderful to see you again. I can't even begin to tell you how much I love and worship the grounds you walk on.
Hey Darren, my creamy potato gratin. It's so wonderful to be reunited with you. My goodness, how I've missed you. I did have an encounter with the League of Entitled Karens, but I managed to sneak some sleeping draught so powerful that it knocked the main ringleader out for several hours.
It was absolutely brilliant, Dad. We caught Alan as soon as we hit Karen the Karenson with the sleeping draught, and she was swiftly arrested and put into one of those corporate prison cells. She will surely have the shock of her life when she wakes up.
You've got to admit, it was a great idea Adam and Lozzie came up with. This hotel has got everything you ever need, and it's well protected, which means that no harm can befall us while we're down here.
It even has a telescope which shows you what's going on, and, ooh, it looks like the main ringleader of the Alanastiums is about to get carted out of this neighborhood. His parents have now shown up, and believe me, they are not impressed.
And sure enough, Roscoe was right. Let's now go over to the park because I want to see what is going on as well. I would love to see how the main ringleader of the Alanastiums is about to have his world turned upside down.
Alan Huntington, out of all things wrong you've ever done in your life, this has got to be the worst thing you've ever done. Joining the League of Entitled Karens, in order to try and drive Darren out of here. Just what on earth has gotten into your mind as of late?
I am saying nothing, Dad.
Alan, you do not speak to your father like that. How dare you? Now then, are you going to explain to us how you deemed it appropriate to- Oh, hang on a moment, I'm getting rained on.
Don't worry, my peachy mango surprise. That's not rain, that's water from a melting ice sculpture.
Because Brainiac Adam has turned Boris Johnson into an ice sculpture, and he is melting, and since the temperature has reached 40 degrees, I do not think he is going to last much longer.
That's right. Now then, you've got hell to pay, Alan. You will either explain to your parents why you are acting the way you are now, or I'll give you a Brainiac-style punishment week, and with the punishment so hardcore that you will wish you were an object.
You cannot do that. Only someone from Brainiac Science Abuse can do that.
Hello? Is there anyone inside your pea-sized brain? The lights are on, but no one's home. I'll have you know that I'm Brainiac Adam, the one and only. So I think you'll find that I can. Now then, where did I get to? That's right. You will either explain to your parents as to why you are acting the way you are now, or I'll give you a brain exile punishment week.
While Adam and Alan are arguing about what's about to become of one of them, namely Alan Huntington, we are going to go back to the Safe Hotel. A few more families have now entered, and Darren feels that something is about to happen.
It feels good to be down here in the comfort of the Safe Hotel.
Absolutely, my wondrous melon pastry. Does anyone know how long we're going to be down here for?
For as long as necessary, Mom. I'm just going off into the research lab, because I want to help Darren take down the remains of both the evil groups.
I'll go along too, the DMC neighborhood needs us.
I'm still trying to figure out a way that I can help out too. I mean, after all, I am the main leader of this neighborhood,
and I want to ensure that I can protect my hard work. Someone let me out of here, please. I want to go up and help protect 11 years of my hard work.
You need to stay down here, Darren. At least until someone can find a safe solution for all of us to control.
Geraint, my universe is about to turn upside down. I can't just stay down here and let that happen. I mean, we've lost to Alanastians, which is good, but there is still a big amount of danger lurking inside of my neighborhood, and the longer I stay down here, the more my conscience is going to eat at me.
I understand, Darren, I really do. However, you must stay down here until a meeting has been called by Lozzie, and she can't do that while at least one of the ringleaders of these troublesome groups remains.
Well, I am going to find a way to get out of here, and stick up for myself, and take back control of my neighborhood, once and for all, even if it means leaving the DMC neighborhood itself.
You can't do that yet, Darren. Look at everyone around you. We'll all be devastated if you went out and were captured again by the League of Entitled Karens.
James, brother, what would you do if your universe is in a state of ruin, and you want to protect it?
Well, I would try and protect it, but from the inside of four walls of safety.
That might be what you would do, but I'm going to protect my neighborhood. Now then, I'm getting out of here, but I won't be gone for too long.
Well, that's just happened, but my husband has always been like it. With dedication comes determination, that's what he's always said.
I just wish Dad would listen to the advice he was given. It was given to protect him.
And now, goodness knows what's going to happen. Let's have another look in the telescope and see what happens.
We're crossing back over to the park where Darren has joined the rest of the team. Boris Johnson, the ice sculpture, has now completely melted and has now reduced the number of Alanastiums down to 6. However, 2 more are set to be in danger of getting thrown out. Adam sees Darren and was instantly concerned.
Darren, my good buddy, what are you doing outside the safe hotel?
I've come to help you take down the remains of these 2 evil groups.
Darren, we put you down in the safe hotel so that you will be safe from what's about to happen. The Adamantiums and I are very well protected, and nothing will harm us. But you, on the other hand, need as much protection as you possibly can. Your family are worried sick about you as well. Lizzie run me as soon as you had left.
Well, if I die trying to save the DMC neighborhood, well, so be it. Everyone else will be protected from these 2 groups. I'm not going anywhere, unless I can save my hard work, which has taken 11 long and hard years of graft to get me to where I am. I will go wherever I'm needed, and here is where I'm needed.
Oh, police. That is such a silly and self-centered sentiment. Now then, you will either get yourself out of here, or I'm going to shoot you.
You do that. Go on. At least I can say the tie-dyed whilst protecting the DMC neighborhood and all 11 years of my hard work from the likes of you. You may take my life, but you'll never take my people, or the neighborhood that I've worked so hard on, in order to make it the way it is.
You can just keep telling yourself that useless piece of junk. Come on, Taren, let's take Darren down, so that we never have to hear his rubbish ever again.
You said what now? Karen Stacy Dafoe. If you're going to kill Darren, you'll have to get through me.
Karen Dafoe makes a shoot at Darren, aiming at the heart, but it went round and punctured his left eardrum and hitting him in the brain. Darren crumples down in a heap, and as he stopped breathing, a ray of light leaves him, showering everyone with a type of protection that can't be broken. Let's go back to the drama that's about to unfold.
Wait, did you see that? Darren's been shot, and he's spread protection across the DMC neighborhood. Now then, you lot just wait. I'm going to take you lot down, and there is nothing that you will do to stop me either.
You go, Adam. Now then, Alan Huntington. We're going back home, and a punishment week is awaiting you when we get back home.
You're going nowhere near me, Father. I am protected by the League of Entitled Karens, so you cannot touch me.
If you thought that the DMC neighborhood was safe, you haven't seen anything yet.
That's right. And we're going to stop at nothing until we get what we want. So tomorrow, I will ring the ombudsman and have the deeds transferred over to my name.
Wait. What did I just hear you say? Karen Stacy Dafoe, you absolute first-class bitch. How dare you deem it appropriate to shoot Darren? And then you still gloat over it. You are so unreal, and now you are going to get it.
Did you just insult me, Adam? That does it. I am not going to stand here and let you get away with that.
Karen Dafoe tried to take Brainiac Adam into the den of the League of Entitled Karens, but his sandals are stuck to the floor like a pair of magnets. James was absolutely thrilled by this and vowed to avenge Darren's death.
I'd better let the rest of the family know about what's happened to Darren. I will say this, they will be very upset indeed. After that, I will help in protecting this neighborhood. It would have been what Darren had wanted.
Would you like me to come along too, James? It's probably best that I say something too.
With that in mind, the memories of Darren will never fade from those who thought highly of him, and much to the demise of whoever remains of the League of Entitled Karens and the Alanastians, a ghost of Darren will soon arrive, and he'll help the Adamantians take down these two groups. Alan Huntington will soon get his comeuppance. He doesn't know it's happening, but it will do eventually. Adam and James went back inside the safe hotel and told everyone what happened to Darren, and they start getting prepared for the battle that's about to unfold in this neighbourhood. We're now back inside the safe hotel, and everyone now knows about Darren's death and how he did it to protect everyone in the DMC neighbourhood. With the safety now returned to the neighbourhood, all citizens, apart from whoever remains in the League of Entitled Karens and the Alanastians, whose numbers have now reduced to 5 since its main ringleader, Alan Huntington, has been escorted out by his parents.
Oh no, not my husband. I mean, I know he did it to protect us all, but it doesn't take away the fact I still miss him.
I know the feeling, Mum. Our dad was the absolute best, and we can't bear to imagine what life would be like without him.
We've got to do something. We wouldn't want it so that all efforts were seen to have been in vain.
Darren was a great person, and now since we're all protected, we will be taking down the remainder of the two Karens and the Alanastia.
We'll leave the decision-making to the second in command, which is Sarah. I mean after you're, she is Darren's wife.
Of course. So tell us what you'd like us to do, Sarah. We'll be on it right away.
Thank you very much, Lachlan. We need to work on upgrading the traps, so that they are 100% foolproof and are completely effective in their purpose.
I am the lady for that task, Sarah. My skunk trap is proving to be very effective. Two members of the Alanostiums have triggered them off, and are either gagging or throwing up.
That's something worth making note of, Jonakaya. I have also conducted some research into how we can take the remaining Alanarciums down.
I'm devising how we're going to take down another member. Warrior was allergic to mushrooms, so I'm going to make him his favorite soup, and then I'm going to lace it with all the juices of 15 different mushrooms.
But Adam, how does the mushrooms affect him? I don't think I've seen anything like it.
You know that Mario uses mushrooms to help him grow?
Absolutely, Adam. I used to play Super Mario Land, until I kept on dying.
If Wario has mushrooms, that will make him shrink. The more mushrooms he has, the smaller he becomes, until he becomes the size of a drawing pin.
Well, this is definitely something worth noting.
Guys, I've just found something out with one of the League of Entitled Karens.
What's that, Aiden? This is getting very exciting indeed.
Well, James, I figured out the very same thing too. Bessie Thatcher can't eat fish. She says it makes her bowels open up like a waterfall.
But how will that assist in taking her down?
It's going to keep sending her to the bathroom, and she's going to cause such a stink that it'll scatter everyone far and wide.
And then my skunk traps will end up triggering as they attempt to leave the den.
This is such amazing work, guys. Darren would have been pleased to see this happen.
But who's going to cook the fish dish for Bessie Thatcher?
I can take care of that. I'm a specialist in sushi.
That would be a brilliant idea, my summer cherry Bakewell. Now then, let's get these ideas off the paper and into action.
We have a breakthrough on the TV. The team at Admiral have received a report of what's happened to Darren, and they are coming over to help.
That's absolutely brilliant, Connor. Thanks for letting me know. I'll be sure to welcome them with open arms. After all, I used to work with them. And by the time this is done, I vow to get out of that strawberry field and back into Admiral. I swear, with all the strawberries I've eaten to help the deal and eat, I'm surprised my skin hasn't turned red.
I've been to that strawberry field, and some of them had become rotten because they were neglected.
This is something definitely worth noting.
So, this is the safe hotel you were talking about, Adam? It looks amazing. All the hard work you and Lossie put into this.
Absolutely, Luke. But with Darren no longer around, I think we should give him a proper send-off. What do you guys think?
I think a funeral may need to take place here. I still can't believe he did that for all of us.
It's almost like what happened in Harry Potter, where he dies to protect everyone. Spoiler alert for those who haven't watched it, but I think it's important to include that part.
Officers Susan, Jerry and Pete are in the house, and we've received report that there's some bold and excellent adventures that are taking place down here, and wondered if we can help you in any way.
You most certainly can, Officer Susan, but Sarah is in charge of giving everything the go-ahead.
I'm going to approve everything that takes place. I am going to do this for Darren. It's what he did for us, and I am going to carry the torch for him.
Well then, what are we waiting for? We'll go and make the fish dish for Bessie Thatcher, and I reckon we'll throw in some cold and spicy lumpy potatoes as well.
And I'll go and make some of Warrior's favorite soup, but I'll lace it with the juice of 25 mushrooms. Let's see what he will make of this one. I don't think he would drink too much of it. He'll go to shrink down to the size of a drawing pin by the time I finish with him.
And I'll think of something to help you take down the remaining Alanistons.
Say, Aiden, my creamy strawberry cheesecake. I think we need to disguise the fish so that Bessie won't know what's hit her.
I know just the thing, my wondrous minty toffee. How about we disguise the fish inside the lumpy potatoes? Or even better still, we can mix the fish inside the lumpy potatoes. That way we can have her upchuck and open up like a fountain at the same time.
That sounds like a rather dangerous idea, my raspberry pecan slice. Let's get to it, straight away. Bess is not going to know what's going to hit her, but she will do, eventually.
Absolutely. I couldn't think of anything better than to see that first class witch go down, once and for all.
Come on, kids. We need to make a move downstairs. Your nan has called us, because we need to make funeral arrangements for your dad. I still can't believe I have to pick flowers for my own husband, but I'm staying strong, because that's what he would have wanted.
We're right behind you, Mum. I can't believe that Dad passed away before we did.
So, with that in mind, everyone starts to get prepared to take down another two members of them evil groups. Aiden and his girlfriend make the fish-induced cold and spicy lumpy potatoes for Bessie Thatcher, and Adam makes the mushroom and juice soup for Wario. Let's go back to the preparations for Darren's funeral, because it's important that we give him the send-off he deserves.
Now, it's important that we give Darren a proper send-off, seeing that he did what he did to protect us all.
You're absolutely right, Joe. Now then, what would you like us to do?
I would like to get some flowers for Darren. Mainly ones that show great courage and leadership.
We'll be able to find somewhere to find some flowers.
I don't know what to say about this situation. I can't quite believe that a mother has to choose a wreath for her own son, who, by the way, died as a hero.
I still can't believe that's happened, though. It's always nice to know when a hero rules over us, but it hurts when they're gone.
It sounds both heartwarming and heartbreaking at the same time.
I just noticed something in the telescope.
Same here. Vario is stomping his feet up and down, whilst covering his nose and his whisker.
Oh sweet. That means my skunk traps win again. Team YouTube Alliance for the win.
I can also see a mini tornado swirling around the den of the League of Entitled Karens.
Wait. Is that a Hoover I can see causing the tornado?
I can see that too. Wow. Freddie Mercury has done some upgrades to his Hoover.
And indeed he has. The tornado coming out of Freddy's Hoover had sucked up the whole den that was once the den of the League of Entitled Karens. People have started to pile out of the safe hotel to see this achievement. We arrive back at the park to find that the remaining troublemakers in the League of Entitled Karens and the Alanastians throwing an epic tantrum. Freddie Mercury was able to suck up the whole den using his trustworthy Hoover, and thus sucking up any research of the entitled virus that they had planned on, plus the virus itself that was 95% complete. In fact, the only thing that remained is the toilet that Bessie Thatcher is sitting on. Brainiac Adams' fish and lumpy potato mess had done the trick, as Bessie was sat there on the toilet for 4 hours.
Why the bloody hell am I still sat on this toilet? Adam, you're going to get it when I am finished on this toilet.
Nice try, Bessie, but I don't think I want to come anywhere near your smelly arse. The next thing I know is that you're going to be shriveled up into nothing, and I'll be jumping down up and down to joy. All I can say is I finally beat my own Karen.
You'll pay for this, Adam Hughes. I can't believe you did this to me.
No, silly. If you want to get yourself recovered from your smelly fishy episode, then you'll have to pay for it.
You thought that was bad, Bessie. Look at me. I have shrunk down to the size of a porcelain doll. I look absolutely ridiculous.
And you found it too, Wario. Good job my mushroom soup did the trick. There were 25 different types of mushroom juice I snapped inside your soup.
You're going to get this.
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
Oh, wow. As if I have to see this mess. Well done, Freddy. Your trustworthy Hoover saved the day.
What is the meaning of all this rubbish? Where has the den gone? And what on earth happened to Bessie Thatcher and Wario?
Well, you can figure that one out for yourself, Karen Safety Dafoe. I did something to them, and now they're suffering the consequences. That's what you lot get for causing all this unnecessary trouble inside the DMC neighborhood.
When are you going to get it into your head that this is now my neighborhood? Darren's dead, and the deeds have now been transferred into my name.
Now that has got to be the biggest lie I have ever heard in my entire life. I can't believe you just said that.
And I can't believe it's not butter.
That's enough. If you think I'm in the mood for joking around after you shot Darren, then you are tragically mistaken.
Absolutely. Now then, I believe that a corporate prison cell is missing a prisoner, so come with me, and I will take you to the police station. Now.
Nice one, Sarah. You just had the main person of this movie locked up.
I'm sorry I'm late, guys. What did I miss out on?
Half of the Allen Arseums have now met their doom. The main ringleader of this movie, along with Karen McArenton, are now in prison and can no longer get out, and Bessie's bowels have opened up like a waterfall.
This is absolutely brilliant, James. I can't believe I missed out, though. I was kept in the safety of my parents, of whom I love to pieces.
And things are only going to get better. If you're wondering what happened to the Alanisteums, well, I'll let Adam explain it.
The mask is now a puddle of sludge inside my house. Boris Johnson has turned into an ice sculpture, which has since melted. Alan is escorted out by his parents, and now Wario has become the size of a porcelain doll.
Oh look, I think something else is about to happen.
Oh, and not forgetting to mention, the den is no more. I've sucked it up with my Hoover, and now all that's left is the toilet that Bessie is sitting on, and the foul stench that's coming off it.
Yeah, I was kind of wondering what that smell was.
It's me, because Brainiac Adam has fed me cold and spicy lumpy potatoes and has mixed fish in with it. I'm allergic to fish, yet he chose to feed me with it anyway.
Let that be a lesson for trying to take over the DMC neighborhood, you self-entitled little prune. I, Officer Geraint, has arrived to catch the drama and... Oh my goodness, that is a bloody horrible smell wafting from the toilet over there.
It's coming from me, officer. That man you're standing next to is...
Called Brainiac Adam, the one and only, and I fed you with cold and spicy lumpy potatoes mixed with some fish. Now do us all a favor and shut your fucking mouth.
Did you just swear at me?
Too fucking right I did, Bessie. If you had a problem with that, then I suggest you go to someone who gives a fuck. Because I sure as hell don't.
Adam, I can't believe you did that. That's it. You're going to get this. Officer, arrest this man right now. He swore at a lady of class.
Not a fucking chance, lady. You deserve what you got from the trouble you caused within this neighborhood. I'm arresting you for your absolute nonsense, and I believe a corporate prison cell is waiting for you.
I'm getting caught for doing good deeds for a friend, and I would have got away with it if you didn't poke your nose in where it isn't wanted.
I won't tell you again, Betsy. Shut that fucking cake hole of yours right now. Get into my car and face your prison sentence.
That is the first time I've heard Officer Jerry swear. I must say, I'm both shocked and impressed.
Me too, Officer Susan. Maybe hanging around with Adam has brought him out of his shell.
You can certainly count on that, officers. He's grown super confident in his line of work. Not that it wasn't in the first place. It's just a few brainiac experiments I had up my sleeve that obliterated three of the Alanartiums and three members of the League of Entitled Karens.
Come on, Officer Peter. We'll make a phone call to our offices. Officer Jerry needs to have a promotion for his hard work inside the DMC neighborhood.
Watch out, Officer Erine. You've got a promotion coming your way.
That's just given me a perfect idea as to what I can do with that wary porcelain doll over there who is throwing a tantrum like a little baby.
Great work, Freddy. There is some serious progress going on here. The League of Entitled Karens are now down to 3 members, and the Alanartiums are down to 4.
Oh my goodness. It sounds like evil is losing its grip over the DMC neighborhood. We'll be able to celebrate soon.
And with the main ringleader now stuck inside a corporate prison cell which has no lock,
we can get ever closer to finishing off both groups, once and for all.
Darren. You've returned. But you're a ghost.
That's right, James. I've come back to help take down the remaining members of the League of Entitled Karens and the Alanartiums. What have I missed so far?
The mask is now a sludge puddle in my house. Bojo was turned into an ice sculpture by the one and only, and he has since melted.
The ringleader of the Alanartiums
has now returned, and I am going to take revenge on Mr. Graniac.
Adam, the one and only?
Adam, when are you going to stop saying that you are the one and only?
When it hits minus 500 degrees Celsius in Antarctica.
Which is never, since you can't go any lower than absolute zero, and that is zero Kelvin, which in Celsius is minus 273. I'll tell you one thing you're going to do.
Yeah, and what is that, then?
You are going to shut the fuck up, or else I am going to make you shut up. Do I make myself clear, you first-class troublemaking fuckpot?
Oh, so you're swearing at me now, are you?
Too fucking right I am, Alan. If you have a problem with that, then I suggest you go to someone who gives a fuck, because I sure as hell don't.
Right then, answer me this, Adam. When have you become so brave as to drop language as strong as that?
I've become brave since having to look at your pig-ugly face for the last 2 years, and I'm telling you now, I'm going to deal with you once this battle is over.
Darren does not usually do swearing in his animations, but what about your police officer?
You mean Officer Geraint? He dropped two as well, but he had the right to, since that fat troublemaker of mine wouldn't stop running that motor mouth of hers. Now then, you will either shut your cake hole, or I will turn you into a motor car and crash you into a tree.
Wow, oh my goodness. Uti musti suffer, esque ar torment of cabin de tos on drike amo torza reverit ime I cave to armit de feat.
That's it. You asked for this, Alan.
Adam turns Alan into a motor car and crashes him into a tree, completely obliterating the bonnet and rendering Alan out of action.
Good riddance to bad rubbish. That's what I've got to say about Alan Huntington. Now that reduces the Alanartiums down to 3.
Just what the bloody hell was that noise all about?
The sound of Brainiac Adam driving your main ringleader into a tree, and rightfully too, you two-faced little squeal bag.
And who are you, speaking to me like that?
My name is Joni Cott, and I am the one responsible for those first-class skunk traps that were in a circle around that now non-existent den of yours. If you think you can win me over, you are tragically mistaken.
Wow. You are one brave girl, Jonikia.
Me? A little girl? I'll have you know, Quan Chi,
that I happen to be a young lady with much more class than you lot put together.
You go, girl. You should be proud of yourself.
Thank you very much, my good buddy. I am feeling great right now.
Okay then, if you think you're so brave, take this.
Oh no you don't, Jessica. Joni Carr is my good friend. If you plan to take her out, then you are going to have to get through me first. And as I'm now a ghost, you can't kill me again, and also my powers have increased, so you are going to have a much harder time trying to contain me.
Now then, I might be a troublemaker, but I am going to defend Darren's honor, and I'm going to cause you as much trouble as I possibly can, and then we'll see who'll be laughing on the other side of their face.
It'll be nice to have a troublemaker stand by us.
Now then, who's with me when it comes to saving the DMC neighborhood?
Absolutely. Come on, guys. Let's save the DMC neighborhood.
And now the battle is about to conclude with only three members of both the Alanastians and the League of Entitled Karens remaining. Things are going to go off with a bang. Darren has returned as a ghost and is 10 times stronger than before. With this in mind, the research that had taken place between the YouTube Alliance and the Adamantians is really starting to pay off. And with Freddy's Hoover sucking up the den of the League of Entitled Karens, the two remaining groups are running out of options and they are starting to panic. We're still at the park, but it's now the following day. It seems that crashing Alan Huntington into a tree didn't work because he managed to revive himself and once again tries to cause a stir for everyone inside the DMC neighborhood.
Oh my word, I am back and am springing into action. Now then, someone is coming, and it looks like that very person I hate.
Oh for fuck's sake, Alan. I thought I got rid of you.
Yeah, and then I revived myself. I am now looking you directly in the face, and...
You absolutely hate it? Nowhere near as much as I do, Alan. You're an absolute first-class twit.
Well then, I demand that you put things right, and then I will be spared of having to look at you. I want you to do that, right now.
Not a fucking chance, you little fuckball. Now then, before I end up swearing like a trooper, Alan, I'm gonna have to get some water. But first off, I'm gonna have to stick your feet to the floor so you can't move.
You've got some serious nerve to be doing that to me, Adam. I don't believe you.
I was going to reply with, I can't believe it's not butter, but I'm not going to stoop to your level.
Before Adam was able to get himself a water, the rest of the Alanastians have arrived and their number stands at 5. Five, because I'd forgotten.
To shut your gaping keckhole.
You do not insult the narrator of this movie, Quan Chi. How dare you even deem it appropriate? Now then, you five are going to answer me, or you are going to do it now. You've got a choice. You can either come clean about the nonsense you're causing inside the DMC neighborhood, or I'm going to have to punish the fuck, living fuck out of you all. Your choice. But my time, it is my time you're wasting.
I don't know why you're including me in this, Adam. I've done nothing wrong.
You might have not done anything, Constance, but you're still part of the Alanathium.
Thanks for sharing that with us, Captain Obvious.
You're welcome, but next time, I'll be charging you.
Oh no you won't.
This isn't a bloody pantomime, Constance. This is the entitled movie of Karen Dafoe, not Aladdin or Snow White. I'm warning you, if you don't shut that mouth of yours, then I'll send the clown of rains on your parade.
Will someone free me from this glue? It's getting stronger and stronger, and I feel like I'm going to melt.
The glue only affected the mud, because he is made out of toxic and poison. Now then, for the second time, Alan, shut your fucking mouth right now, or I will scream so loudly that it'll deafen you! Is everything okay, Adam? I can hear a lot of, and now I know why. Just what in all kinds of fuck are you guys doing here? Don't worry, officer. I'm gonna take all of them down. Would you like to enjoy how it's about to unfold? I would love to, Adam. Go on, and give the Alanathians your absolute work. Now then, you five, you will answer my questions, and you will answer them truthfully. If any of you speak out of turn, you are going to get in the neck from me.
Officer Geraint becomes worried about what might become of Adam and calls back at the police office for some backup.
Alan Dubry, I'm going to need some backup. Brainiac Adam is up to something with the Alanastium, and I worry they are going to harm him.
We're coming, Officer Geraint, but Adam plans to take them all down single-handedly, and we must not stop him. We can assist, but we must not stop Adam from conquering his own troubles.
We'll let Adam do what he does best, and I reckon we should give him a plaque for his heroic work.
Meanwhile, back with Adam and the Alanastians, things are starting to get interesting. The remaining members are still running their mouths, and Adam has had enough.
You just wait, Adam Hughes. I am going to get you for this imprisonment you've tracked me up in.
I have just about had enough of you, Alan. Now for the last time, shut your fucking mouth right now. Does your pea-sized brain understand this?
Adam screams this so loudly that it's powerful enough to deafen two of the Alanastians.
Adam, that was fucking brilliant. I'm so proud of you. I didn't even realise your screen can do that. Come on, let's get you a big bottle of water so you're able to calm yourself down. You know what? I'm all fired up, and I'm going to royally give out those punishments. I'll let you carry on then, but let me get you a bottle of water. And I'll chuck it over Constance and have her melting like the Wicked Witch. That's a brilliant idea, Adam. Let's get you a jug of water.
As Officer Geraint exits, the other two officers arrive and they've caught wind of Adam's achievement.
Well, well, well. What a fine mess you've gotten yourselves in.
If it wasn't for Brainiac Adam, then I wouldn't be in this mess. Quanchi and Constance have become deafened by him, and things are getting worse for us. We are down to 5 in our group.
Which is about to become 4. Quanchi, take this one aside, you sleazy little fuckwit.
Adam has another one of his Brainiac moments and has turned Quanchi into a statue of stone. Quanchi tries to call out not fair, but only half the sound could come out, since stone silences all the sound that comes out.
No!
You will get your just deserts, Adam. I promise you that when people hear of you, it'll be when I've taken control of the DMC neighborhood and said goodbye to your sad and pathetic little butt.
My sad and pathetic little butt. Alan, you sleazy little fucker. I can't believe that you just said that. I'll have you know that my sad, pathetic little butt single-handedly took half of you down, and I'm going to own you, Alan, big style. Now then, if I have to tell you to shut the fuck up once more, I will use a famine spell on you.
Now then, I better heed that warning if I were you.
And who the hell are you telling me what to do?
My name is Lachlan Brown, and I came here from Adelaide, South Australia. I came here to assist taking down the League of Entitled Karens. I am leaving the Alanastians in the capable hands of Brainiac Adam.
The one and only. Now then, where did I get to? Oh, that's right. I have a stone cutter, so I reckon I can have Quanchi cut down to size.
Adam takes a stone cutter and cuts the stone statue of Quanchi into tiny pieces. This takes the Alanastians down to 4, and in the wise words of Freddie Mercury,
another one bites the dust, or in this case, another one's cut to bits. Would you like me to suck the stone parts up? I can use my trustworthy Hooper for this job.
Yes, please, Freddy. I'll be jumping up and down when he gets sucked up.
Well then, let's not waste any more time. We have a stone pile to get rid of.
Freddy sucks up the stone particles with his Hoover, and as we expected, Adam jumps up and down for joy at the victory.
Now this is worth calling for some celebration. Great job, Adam and Freddy.
Thanks, James. However, I still have 4 pathetic excuses for Alanastians left to go. And ooh, I think some water's come in.
Welcome back, officer. I'm so glad that you came back.
I came with some water because I found out something about one of the Alanastians.
Same thing here. If you chuck water over one of them, they will melt into a puddle.
I'll just hand the water over to Adam, and then you can sit back and watch the drama unfold.
Officer Geraint goes over to Adam and gives him the jug of water. After that, he goes back and sits with the other officers to watch everything unfold.
Now then, I have a jug of water, and if one of you particularly gives me any grief, I will not hesitate to chuck it over you. I know all of your weaknesses. The because I put you in this group.
You are not going to chuck that thing over me, Adam. You trust me way too much for this monstrosity.
Oh, do I now, Constance? Well, take this one for size, you little witch.
Now, with that in mind, Adam takes the jug of water and chucks it all over Constance. As we all suspected, she starts to melt and becomes like the Wicked Witch of the West.
You cursed brat! Look what you've done! I'm melted! Melted! Oh, what a world! What a world! What a world! Who would have thought that a good little boy like you could destroy my wickedness? I'm going!
Now that horrible witch Constance is gone, you're now down to 3 members. Who else is going to be for the chop? I'm warning you, if any of you speak out of turn, you will be next to meet your doom.
Now, who would ever dare to do that to any of us? We're just sweet little angels.
With a rusty halo on top, I'm warning you, Dagon. If you so much as utter as one more word, you'll be next to meet your doom. I'm not scared of some little dipshit like you.
Say, James, this is something definitely worth watching. Adam's doing a great job.
That, I must agree with you on, Lachlan. Oh wait, some more people are coming to watch Adam take down his troublesome group.
Now with that in mind, people from the YouTube Alliance come in, and using beyond logic, they were able to just teleport into the park.
We've now arrived at the park. What have we missed out on?
Quan Chi was turned into a statue, and Adam used his stone cutter to chop it up.
And he chucked water over Constance and she melted into a puddle.
And now it looks like he's about to do something to Dagon.
Now this, I've got to see. This is the type of drama I don't want to miss.
I can't believe the drama that's about to unfold, but at the same time, I'm very excited to see this going down.
Oh, my goodness. So now, we're down to 3 Alanostiums. I'm so very excited that I can't contain myself. Now then, let's watch Adam take down another one.
And now we cross back over, as another Alanostium has spoken out of turn and swore badly at Adam. So badly, in fact, that Adam's had enough.
Dagon, did you just drop the C-word on me? You absolute first-class fucking arsehole. You do not ever speak to me like that and expect me to get away with it. Now then, take your punishment, you little fuckball.
Adam's throat was starting to get sore with the screaming, but it deafened both Dagon and Jessica at the same time. Everyone was impressed with what had happened. Now then, let's get back into the action. Adam has had his throat soothed down by Officer Peter so that he can continue with the 3 remaining Alanostiums.
Now, because you deemed it appropriate to call me that horrible word, you will be next to meet your match.
Adam turns Dagon into a glass statue, and since he's in mortal combat, we are going to treat his death in the same way.
Finish him! Adam Hughes wins. Flawless victory. Fatality!
Everyone celebrates at this point. Adam has picked up the glass Dagon and threw him down, smashing him into thousands of tiny pieces. Freddy picked these up in his Hoover.
You just wait, Adam. You're going to get this for taking down my favorite Mortal Kombat character.
Jessica runs over and grabs Adam's arm, but the material on his t-shirt gives her an electric shock, and it was powerful enough to turn her into dust. Now, with just Alan remaining without his croons, he's got nowhere left to run. It was revealed that Alan's croons were making him immortal, and now he's returned back to normal.
Well, now it's just you and me now, Alan. You've got nowhere to run now, and I can just about do anything with you. Anthony? Oh, wow. We have a whole audience turn up to see me take down that arse of yours. You really messed up, Alan. I mean, you truly fucked up this time, thinking you can get on the same level of protection that Darren gave us. I'm about to turn you into an object, because I believe that was your biggest wish.
How did you manage to work that one out, Adam? Have you been prying your way through my private files?
You're forgetting one tiny detail, Alan. I made you, so of course, I'm going to know everything about your sad and pathetic little arse.
you're going to get this, Adam David Hughes. I don't understand why you think you can continually get one over me. I am the top man after all.
Alan! How the fuck did you manage to work out my middle name? You are so unreal. You are so fucking unreal. And so now, your punishment is awaiting you.
And this is what happened. Brainiac Adam turned Alan into a microwave and threw lit bombs inside it. And the microwave explodes, causing fireworks to shoot outside the framework. Everyone is jumping up and down because the Alanastiums are now no more. The three police officers and Alan Dubry go over to Adam to congratulate him on the hard work.
Now that Adam was absolutely fucking amazing. I'm so very proud of you. Now I shouldn't be swearing as a police officer, but I just couldn't help myself.
Don't worry about the swearing, Officer Geraint. I've dropped a few in my time as an officer. We do, however, have another troublemaking group to deal with.
I have to say, I certainly feel good for doing my part in helping Adam take down the Alanastiums.
Indeed, you did. But remember that Adam was the one who ultimately took them all down.
Lex certainly did, and I couldn't be prouder of him.
Same here. Come along, officers. We have another group to take down.
Absolutely.
Here we are, back inside the prison, and this is where we find all the members of the League of Entitled Karens. The remaining members are still acting up inside their cells. Bessie Thatcher had reduced to a raisin and fell into the mouth of Karen Dafoe, who wasn't too impressed.
I was the first person to be in prison, and I'm the main ringleader of this group.
I don't know what to think about this place. It's making me question as to why I'm even doing here.
Same here. I didn't even do anything wrong, and here I am, suffering for what Darren did.
Darren enters, but because of the way Adam took down the Alanastium single-handedly, it brought Darren back to life, and now he is a human again. As for our hero of the day, well, let's say that Brainiac Adam is recovering in the safe hotel because bits of stone and glass have hit him in the face during the battle. Good news, however, Adam is nearly ready to rejoin the others, and we're all thrilled to bestow him with a special plaque for his hard work.
Oh my word, what a day this has turned out to be. Now then, you've either really screwed up, and I mean, you've totally screwed up something chronic.
I agree with you, Alan. Now then, I believe Darren wants a meeting with you in regards of his two troublemakers.
Okay, Officer Susan, we will hold a quick meeting in a bit. I think Darren might be up to something. And I have a funny feeling it's to do with those entitled stories of Karen Dafoe.
Do you reckon Darren might spare the Dafoe sisters?
I don't know, Officer Geraint, but I reckon if he wants to continue the entitled stories of Karen Dafoe, I do think we might save him. I'll speak to him about it.
I hope something good comes out of this mess, Officer Peter.
I'm sure it will, James. Something good has to come out of this mess.
Having you say that really does put my mind at rest.
I'm glad to hear you say that, James.
I always hope for reassuring outcomes in this neighborhood.
So do we all, James. I can reassure you that this will definitely be the case.
Paul Multiple in the house, and I came here to help out wherever I can.
It's good to see you, Paul. How are things going for you?
They're going well, thanks, Officer Susan. Now then, what needs to be done here?
I'll tell you what needs to happen. Darren needs to be shot up, and fast.
You, Karen McCarrison, need to shut that fucking case call of yours right now.
No, I sure as hell won't.
You sure as hell he will? Or I'll make sure you'll have hell to pay.
And so will I, with the permission of the real Random Lozzy.
Darren, I think I'd better take care of Karen McCarran's son. After all, she is my troublemaker. Of course, if there's anything you can think of that'll help me, I will, of course, welcome it with open arms.
I will do, but in the meantime, Alan, can I speak to you, please? It's concerning the Dafoe sisters.
Of course you can, Darren. Come with me and we'll discuss what you want to do with Karen and Taryn Dafoe.
Now this is going to take everyone by surprise when all is said and done.
I wonder what Darren's going to talk about with Alan?
Hopefully, it'll be to set us free.
I'm not too sure if that is the case, but here's hoping for the best case scenario. Karen, sis, I don't know whether you're feeling the same thing I am. I'm not sure what you're thinking, but I think I'm feeling the very same thing as you.
Now then, I just received a report from Brainiac Adam. He sent Geiger out to eat through a few members of the League of Entitled Karens.
Who will they be, officer? Things are getting very depressing here in this prison, and I want out.
Adam hasn't revealed who Geiger is going to eat, but you'll soon find out who he'll eat.
We'll find out soon enough, but until then, we'll just have to wait and see.
Karen Stacy and Taryn Melissa Dafoe, I have come to bail you out, but I'm going to give you a stark warning. Now I don't usually swear, but this time, I'm going to. I expect you to act entitled, after all, this is based on the entitled stories of Karen Dafoe. However, if you fuck up in this way once more, I'll have you back in these corporal prison cells, and you'll have cold and spicy lumpy potatoes for the rest of your lives, and you'll also get a corporal-style punishment month. Do I make myself clear?
We hear you loud and clear, Darren, and we also know that you're the rightful owner of the DMC neighborhood, and not us.
We're terribly sorry for the way we treated you in this movie, Darren. We promise never to do it again, and that is our solemn promise too.
We want to make a few changes to our show, if we can, Darren.
Of course, you can, Karen. Alan, can you use Vine Logic to get Karen and Taryn Dafoe out of their prison cells, please? I'm going to have a talk with them. After all, they deserve a second chance of a show.
Of course I can, Darren. No problem at all.
Alan uses some Vine Logic to have Karen and Taryn Dafoe released from their prison cells. They were so thrilled that they gave Darren a hug.
Thank you very much for giving us another chance, Darren. We promise that we'll never mess up again.
And we would also like to give up our entitled ways too, Darren. Instead, we'd like to help you in the running of your neighborhood.
Absolutely. As for Adam single-handedly taking down the Alanostiums? Well, let's just say they won't be able to bother us anymore.
Wait, does that mean I'm going to lose two members from the League of Entitled Karens?
Yes. You are, Karen M. As of this moment, Taryn and I want nothing more to do with this pathetic excuse of a club.
I agree with you, sis. Now then, let's get out of here and do something good for a change.
Yes. We're going to go to the safe hotel, and then we're going to use Vion Logic to heal Adam's remaining wounds. He has a special ceremony to attend, and we've got to have him at his best.
Now, I know that Karen and Taryn are being genuinely nice for a change.
Now then, it has come to my attention that I have two troublemaking Karens to eat.
I don't know what you're on about.
I think you'll find you do, and I've waited so long, and have become starving, so I'm naturally going to eat all three of you.
Oh no, not all of us, we promise to behave ourselves.
Likely story, Karen McKerinson. Now then, let's get to eating all three of you.
With that in mind, and with the Dafoe sisters fully reformed, everyone gets prepared for presenting Brainiac Adam with a ceremony for his hard work in conquering the Alanastiums on his own. The preparations will be taking place once he's fully healed. You will also be pleased to know that there's no more swearing after this point. We are now at the hype of preparing for the ceremony of Brainiac Adam, and things are ever buzzing and glowing. Karen and Taryn Dafoe have been helping Darren sort out the invitations. They've been true to their word and have been doing good things since being freed by Darren.
Say Darren, what else would you like us to do? We want to make sure that everything runs as smoothly as possible.
Can you send out invitations to everyone, please? We want to make sure that everyone is able to attend.
Of course we can, Darren. What would you like the invites to say?
Surprise me, Taryn. I trust you can take care of making them something special.
You can certainly count on us for that, Darren. We will stop at nothing until everything is done perfectly.
Thank you very much, Karen. Now that's considered, we need to ensure everything else is prepared.
I can sort out a few things as well, Darren. Let me know what you need me to do, and I will help you wherever I can.
Meanwhile, back in the safe hotel, Adam had his room personalised to fit his bedroom back at his house.
Good morning, world. Brainiac Adam is now up and ready to go. Oh my goodness! What a morning this is turning out to be! Well, in that case, I better get myself sorted, because boy have I got some preparations to be getting on with.
There was a knock at the door. Roscoe and Lizzie had arrived with the good news.
Can you give me a moment, please? I'm just getting myself sorted, and I'll be with you soon.
No worries, Adam. Roscoe and I will head on back up to the main area.
Okay, Lizzie. I promise I won't be long.
Come on, Roscoe, my sweetness. Let's go back up to Mum. I'm sure she'll want us to do something else to help with the prep.
I wonder what Edward is prepping that's so important. Maybe I might be on to something. And I'll need to find my own personal center. In the sense that a single-handedly takes down a whole group of eight of the Alanasium. Now I really need some rest.
15 minutes have passed and Adam still hasn't moved from his bed. People are starting to get concerned. Preparation is in progress, but Adam still hasn't left his room. Lizzie went down again, but this time was met by an upset Brainiac Adam.
Come in, Lizzie.
Oh my goodness. Adam, are you all right? You look like you've been crying.
I haven't been crying this time, but I...
Come here, Adam. Give us a hug. I don't know what's eating at you, but your big day's fast approaching, and we can't do anything if you're on the verge of tears.
You know what? You're absolutely right, Lizzie. I've done something major to save the DMC neighborhood, and I should be happy. So, why do I need to feel the need to cry?
I'm not sure, Adam, but we need to get you perked up before things become too much for you.
That I will do indeed. Hopefully, your dad will be there too.
Karen and Taryn Dafoe are there too.
Wait. What did you just say there?
Karen and Taryn Dafoe are there too, only they've now reformed and are doing everything to ensure your big day runs more smoothly.
Wait, wasn't that the same two who used Beyond Logic to help speed up my glass and stone wound?
Another knock is heard. This time, Darren is standing outside the door.
Come in, Darren. My door is always open to you. Darren, I must commend you for your outstanding level of dedication by giving Karen and Taryn another chance. I mean, look at your face. It feels a whole lot better now. And it's all down to Dafoe sisters for speeding up the recovery.
I gave them a stark warning that if they mess up once more, that I'll put them back in their corporal prison cells and punish them something chronic.
Did you swear at them as well?
Absolutely, Adam. I've now figured out that something like that would set them straight.
That's amazing, Darren. You should be very proud of yourself.
I've come out of my shell, and it feels brilliant.
That's absolutely brilliant. Come on, let's go and get ourselves sorted.
Indeed. So when you're ready, let's go, now.
Guys, I have to say that this ceremony is going to be absolutely epic. If anyone deserves it, it's Brainiac Adam. He's just incredible with how he dealt with the Alanosians.
I agree with you, sis.
Karen and Taryn, it's nice to see you both perform.
Absolutely, Lazi. And we're going to continue to do good things too.
That's brilliant! Come on, Karen and Taryn Dafoe. Let's get some great work on the go.
We're right behind you, Lazi. We've still got some ideas to put to paper.
Say Adam, how would you like to celebrate the successes of receiving your plaque over some dinner?
That actually sounds like a great idea, Darren. However, after celebrating the success, I would quite fancy the idea of going to Barry Island for a week. I think I'll need it after everything I've been through.
That sounds like a brilliant idea, Adam. Do you plan on taking someone with you on that adventure, or do you plan on going there alone?
Darren, why would I ever want to do that alone? I was going to ask if you would like to come along with me. After all, you have been through hell and back. And if anyone deserves the time away, it's you.
Darren, my spicy saucy strawberry. If you want to go on a week away with Adam, I'm not going to stop you, because you totally deserve it, especially after what you've been through.
But what would you do while I'm away, Sarah?
Don't worry about it, my honey drizzle cupcake. I will take care of everything. I want you to be happy, and I really do think a week on Barry Island with Adam will really do you some good.
I'm going to miss you guys. Can I keep in touch with you, please?
Of course, you can, my wondrous toffee pizza.
I'm not going to say anything against that, Darren. Go on. Off you go and have a week on Barry Island with Adam.
Don't forget to send us a postcard, Dad. We'll miss you, but you need the week away.
I agree with everyone here, Dad.
I'll come with you, Adam. After all, everyone's right. I'm going to need the week away.
Now that is the man we all know and love. Come with me, Darren. I will go along to the ceremony. After that, we've got a train to catch to Barry Island.
Absolutely, Adam. So, when you're ready, let's go, now.
Now with less than 5 minutes to go, everyone takes their seats and Karen Dafoe takes it to the stand to give out the award. It comes to show that when someone is redeemed that they truly deserve a second chance. Karen was a bit nervous at first, but she nails it.
First off, I would just like to welcome you ladies and gentlemen to the ceremony of a hero amongst us. He fought a battle with 8 members of the Alanostians, and came up victoriously on top every single time, and so it gives me both the pleasure and honor to give the award for special services to the DMC neighborhood to Mr. Adam Hughes.
Adam goes up and accepts the award, and everyone gives him a standing ovation. It's always nice to see hard work paying off, and in a way that it's going to be remembered. Adam then takes to the stand and delivers his speech.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you for standing by me and believing in me when it came to conquering the Alanostians. I would never would have thought I'd done it if it hadn't been for your encouragement. I would also like to thank the real random Lozzie for helping me build the safe hotel. I'm pretty sure that everyone was well protected during this time. I would also like to thank my 3 hard-working police officers and Alan Dubry for helping me during my times of difficulty. Officer Geraint and I had some proper belly laughs during our time together. Also, I would like to extend a hand of invitation to Darren Stratton for going through the same ordeal that I had to go through when dealing with the League of Entitled Karen. I love you all to bits, my good buddy, and I would love to celebrate my success with you. And I also mustn't forget to thank my group of heroes, known as the Adamantians, for standing by me every step of the way. You show me some real loyalty, and I am truly honoured to be your ringleader. That's all I've got to say, apart from thanks again.
Adam takes a seat next to the Adamantians, and Karen Dafoe concludes the ceremony. After that finishes, Adam goes over and finds Darren, and they spend some time sorting themselves out.
Say, Darren, are you excited for our week out to Barry Island?
Absolutely, Adam. I can't wait to spend some well-earned time with you.
Same here. Things are going to be epic. I'll take care of everything this time. You don't need to worry about a single thing when you're with me.
Thank you very much for always standing by me, Adam. I don't know where I'd be if it wasn't for you, James and Connor.
Hey, it's no problem, Darren. That's exactly what best friends do. We always stand by each other through thick and through thin.
Indeed, we do, Adam. So, what is the first plan of action?
Well, I thought the idea of having dinner at one of those fancy restaurants. Let me lead the way, Darren, and I'll take the very best care of you during the 7 days we spend together.
Thanks again, Adam. I really need this time away.
No worries, Darren. So, are you ready? Let's go now!
And so, Darren and Adam set off at Barry Island, as they both need a week away from the DMC neighbourhood. Sarah was placed in charge while Darren was away. Karen and Karen Dafoe remained true to their word and helped maintain harmony. Peace has once again returned to the DMC neighbourhood, and everyone can once again live the life it has to offer.
Hey, you wonderful DMC winners, it's your main ladies, Karen and Taryn Dafoe. We would like to thank you for taking the time to watch my movie.
We would like to say thank you to Darren Stratton for giving us a second chance at a show, so we would like to announce this. We will be scrapping the entitled stories of Karen Dafoe, and we'll be replacing it with a brand new show.
Absolutely. The name of our show is called Tales of the Dafoe Sisters. This is where Taryn and I go around living a normal life, and help people out as and wherever needed. We can't wait to present this to you, but for now, let's pass the time back over to Darren, because the fun is far from over.
Absolutely, sis. So when you're ready, let's go, now.